Hame, a new game.
Yep.
A new game for the people show. It's always exciting when you when you're just strolling up to the studio going, ooh, can't wait to play this.
This will be fun.
And it's a hard one.
This is hard. And this is an honesty system on our side of things. But this was developed when we were all just sitting around earlier on.
Mm.
And I think it came up when Jack said, tell me someone from Big Brother that I wouldn't remember. From any season of Big Brother that I wouldn't remember. So we were like, you know, instinctively a few people got too excited and yelled out, you know, Merlin. And then Jack's like, nope, I remember him.
Well, Carly said Sarah Marie.
And then Jack's like, nope, Bum Dance, remember
and
her.
And then I think I jumped in with Shana.
Shana the banana.
Yeah, and that was when Jack went, ooh, who's
well
Shana?
Done.
And I was like, I've won, and I don't care to tell you who she is, but I've certainly won.
And then I said Russell.
Yeah.
And I don't think there has been a Russell, but I realised there was a loophole in the game where Jack could say, well, I don't know him, and I could get you season 3. It was really funny. Red-headed guy.
But it got us to thinking of a new game.
Okay, so here's don't call up about that game because that's not the game we're playing.
That's not the game.
But that's what inspired the game we're about to play, which is tell Andy and I someone we haven't thought about in a while. You don't think we would have thought about, but obviously we need to know who that person is.
Now, should we, between the two of us, be deciding on how long a while is?
Well, it just has to be like, oh, yeah.
So to me,
I haven't thought about
Jenny McCarthy.
I was going to say Joey from Blossom. The guy's like, whoa, whoa. You know, from that sitcom of the 90s. Yeah. I haven't thought about him for a while. Congratulations. You just won yourself a hat.
Okay, yes, we did get sent some hats, and Hamish is now on sending them. it's an on send.
I think we might have said in passing that, you know, when Daniel Ricciardo, the Formula One driver, came on the other day, we said,
for Red Bull, yeah.
You know, it was disappointing he didn't bring us free hats. I was really, he was such a great guy that I was really trying to find anything to be disappointed with.
Yeah.
So the Formula One team sent us a bunch of hats.
Yep.
So that's what you could win.
Win a hat. Hey, again, as far as a while goes, to me that's like the last 3-4 months.
Yeah.
Like maybe even this year. If we were thinking of this person, say early December last year, we could pinpoint it.
Yeah.
We go, oh, no, we watched that film that person was in, December 10, around there.
Yep.
Are we going to say that we haven't thought of them for a while?
I'll give you one you might not have thought of for a while, Andy. Stephen Baldwin.
Oh, yes. No, I have. Unfortunately, you would.
Well, this is great. This is how the game can work. When did you think of him?
Well, the other night, because Beck was talking about Alec Baldwin, and I said, you realize there's a lot of Baldwins, because remember, I showed her The Usual Suspects for the first time.
All right, well, that's Stephen.
And that is Stephen, but then we were talking about William as well. So,
Billy.
Beware of all Baldwins, everyone.
I'm name Baldwins. I've only thought of Alec recently, but actually now having talked to Ando, I've thought of all of them as well. So you wouldn't win if you rang up with any Baldwin, because we have thought about them recently.
Yeah, recently. I'm going to say this year it kind of constitutes a while.
Yeah. So just really be careful. Yeah. Really think hard. And it's a tough game to win because the first thing that comes to your head is probably going to be someone we've thought about.
That's Hamish and Andy. Hyped up about a new game called Tell Us Someone We Haven't Thought About for a While.
So if you come on board, you come on the show and you say, hey guys, don't think you would have thought about Wilbur Wilde from Hey Hey It's Saturday for a while.
That's a good one. Because I haven't.
I haven't.
Yeah.
I don't know how I got him then from my brain.
Yeah.
But I think I just asked my brain to give me someone who I wouldn't have thought about for 6
months.
I
last thought about him August last year.
I almost.
I'll tell you why. He used to love this golf pro-am that got cancelled, and I bumped into the person who ran it.
Yep.
And I said,
it's fine. August is fine.
I said, it's a shame. No, I said, it's a shame. It's like I had. And that person said, Wilbur Wilde's actually the most disappointing.
He'd be really good.
So I was like, wow, okay.
And you went to bed without knowing it that night, going, and I shan't utter Wilbur Wilde's name until March next year. You never know. You never know you're going to disappear.
March 23rd, this will rear its ugly head.
Yeah.
Elise,
I almost thought about Wilbur Wilde the other day when I was reading that article about the Hey Hey It's Saturday reunion, but now thinking about it, I know I didn't think about it. No offense to him. I was thinking about Daryl and Russell Gilbert. But I didn't think about Wilbur. Elise.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Elise. You've heard how difficult the game is.
Oh, God, yeah.
Okay. Do you think you've got someone that we wouldn't have thought about for a while?
I think I've definitely got someone.
Remember, Elise, this is for a hat.
Mm. Oh, my God. Okay. Mike Whitney from Who Dares Wins.
Ooh.
good one.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
No. It's just that we do think about him a lot.
Fair enough. What about Tanya?
No, sorry, Lisa. You can't have a second crack at it. Unfortunately, two and a half weeks ago, Ham.
We did make a joke about Mike Whitney coming back to play for Australia. You can't have known that, Elise, because that was a private conversation.
Yeah.
I'm so sorry. We have thought about Mike Whitney.
No hat.
Is it just me, or does this feel like it could be a TV game show?
Paige,
for a hat.
Hi.
Hi, Paige.
I feel like if it was a TV game show, Ham, there's terms and conditions if there were prize up for grabs. So you and I would have to go around noting down
every time we thought of someone. But is you and me standing on the stage, and there's like a 50-meter plasma behind us, and spinning around is the graphic for no hat.
Paige, your chance to win a hat.
Yeah, I want a hat.
Yeah, your chance to win one. Who's the person?
Who do you think we haven't thought about in a while?
What about Misha Barton from OC?
Yep, I haven't thought of her. Yeah. That's great, Paige. You got a hat.
Woo! Yeah, have not.
I need a new hat.
Yep, well, you got one. I have not given Misha a skerrick of thought.
No.
Because for a second I thought you meant Keira Knightley, because I get them confused, and I have thought of Keira Knightley.
Close to 8 months since my last Misha Barton.
It'll be ages for me and Misha Barton. Well done, Paige.
Tyler.
Tyler, you've heard how it can be done. That's how simple it is.
Yep.
Ahoy, welcome.
Ahoy.
Tyler, who do you think we haven't thought about for a while?
Farlap.
Nah, sorry, mate.
Think about it. But it's such a good try, Tyler. There's no bad try.
I reckon it is a bad try, I'm going to say, because the very term I have is big as Farlap.
Every week I think of Farlap.
You're
not thinking
about racehorses the other week.
Yeah, but the thing is, every race...
Sorry, I admire the courage, but are you trying to...
I deserve a hat.
Do you know what? I'm going to give you a hat for asking for a hat. I'm going to give you a hat for being the first person to argue that we haven't thought about something when we're saying we have thought about it.
Yeah, but that's the last hat. This hat will we give away under those circumstances.
I also need a ruler.
We are not a shitty Office Works. That you can just ask for things.
No, you got go and get my hats from Officeworks.
Yeah. You can have it, as they say at Officeworks, you can have a hat, but you'll have to pay for the ruler.
Thanks, Tyler. Jody, you're our last...
ruler. We've got about 1,000.
You're our last contestant. You've got a chance to win a hat, a complimentary prize of a 6-inch half bevel. 6-inch.
Slight bevel.
Slight beveled ruler. Hamish and Andy branded ruler.
We will throw in a ruler.
As long as it's signed, it's all good.
It's got a very cheap printed brand of the show on it.
Yeah.
So it's sort of a signature. Jodie, who do you think we haven't thought about in a while?
The Klepto Winona Ryder.
Yeah. I haven't thought about Winona Ryder. You've got it, Jodie.
You got yourself a hat, Jodie.
Awesome.
Well done. And to wrap this up, I think we'll play again for sure.
Oh, every day.
So if there's any other companies that have hats, because we're going to run out of the Red Bull one.
Yeah, that's true.
Please send
I mean, but look, Tyler touched on a good point. Mm. We still do have tons and tons of show merch.
Do you reckon we just play for rulers?
Serviettes, refresher towels.
Feels like a hat. The hat's been...
Okay, if you got a hat, send us in the hat. See if you can get it given away.
Same shandy.
Good afternoon, everyone. Hamish Andy back to drive you home. Hey, and big show.
It is a big show, Ando.
Yes,
regular of course. Straight after this song, we return to one of our favourite segments, a segment launched on the show last week to much acclaim and had a lot of people throwing suggestions at us on Twitter and Facebook all week.
Yeah.
Tell us someone we haven't thought about in a while.
Exactly. That's the game.
Yeah.
Tell us someone we haven't thought about in a while. One alert podcaster who was overseas actually video messaged us.
He was
a concern with the game.
Walking along, listening to the podcast, he's got his headphones in, made a video, put it on Twitter to go, hey guys, just having a thought. There's a loophole in the game.
So let's address the loophole first and then play the game.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, let's do that. I mean, yeah, and then do we tell people now the hat? That they could win if they tell us
something. Let's make sure we address the loophole.
Okay, so you got a loophole and hat info coming up.
Hamish and Andy. Hey,
we've
pumped about this game to play it again.
Yeah.
It's called Tell Us Somebody We Haven't Thought Of For A While.
It's a tough game because you got your go-to funny, obscure people.
Yeah.
Like hot dogs from Big Brother.
Yeah, or the fat kid from Hey Dad.
Yeah, think about him all the time. That's why it's a hard game because people need to call us on 131060 when we open the lines and go, look, I know you got your standards, you know, wouldn't this be funny? But here's someone you really wouldn't have thought about in a long time, yet they are famous, and it's plausible you should have thought about them.
Yeah.
Or you could have thought about them. And what did we say a lot? And I think it's a while. Like
Last 3 months.
Yeah. So if
this
we haven't,
year. We talked about it maybe this year.
If we haven't, for you to win, we have to honestly go, nope, I haven't thought about Alicia Silverstone this year. Well done.
Yeah.
But she's someone I could have thought about.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
But we had a few people.
And what do you win?
You win a hat, Ando.
You win a hat.
Last week, we gave away some great hats.
Yeah.
That were surplus from when we had Daniel Ricciardo on the show. And look, it's a long story, but I complained about not being given a hat. Then Red Bull, the Formula One team, sent us too many hats in, and we had to give away the surplus. Yeah. So we opened the floodgates for hats last week when we said, I think something along the lines of, hey, we're out of hats. Send us more hats.
Whoever's out there.
This is a testament to how popular the segment is, Ando, because we've received no less than 15 shipments of hats.
Yeah.
I've picked one of the shipments at random.
Great.
Today, people will be, if you can tell us someone we haven't thought about in a while, a famous person we haven't thought about in a while, you will win a hat. From the Still Timber Sports Kiss My Axe Festival. Which...
It's a good hat.
I did not read the press release that comes with the hats, but led to believe it's some sort of...
Woodchopping festival.
It's a woodchopping festival. I mean, the logo is two axes and stills are, you know, they make good chainsaws. Yeah, so, you win a timber sports hat.
That's good today.
Timber sports is a...
Before we get into the game...
I've got to be honest, it's a term I hadn't heard before.
Timber sports?
Like, we hear like water sports, ball sports, whatever. Timber sports.
No, I haven't heard metal
timber sports. Sports is just wood chopping. It's not too many... I mean, you wouldn't call cricket...
Whittling?
You wouldn't call cricket a timber sport, although you do play with timber. Hockey, timber sport.
The other thing, Ham, was a young fellow called Dominic Hook.
Yeah.
He was listening to the podcast. You can podcast the show at iTunes or on our app, Hamish and Andy, for the app if you wanted to download it. And he sent us this video outlining a potential loophole or worry he had with the game. Tell us somebody we haven't thought about for a while.
This was a great video too because he's clearly listening to this show and he's just walking along the street somewhere. I don't know what country he's in. Yeah. He's just walking along the streets with his headphones in, musing. It's my favourite form of feedback.
Yeah.
Self-film videos on Twitter. This is Dominic.
Boys, I'm just listening to the podcast and I've thought of not a flaw but a possible new rule that could be involved. So I could go back and say a prime minister from 40 years ago, and you will have heard of them, but clearly they're not popular and mentioned often in this day and age. But maybe you get bonus points if you mention someone that is current and talked about often that you haven't talked about. So it's more of a risk, but for extra points. Just a thought.
It's a good thought.
It's a great rule. And so the Dominic rule is being enacted.
We don't have point system, though.
No.
So we more just...
We'll add a ruler. We'll add a Hamish Andy slight bevel 6-inch ruler, very, very limited edition, branded merchandise ruler. Great for tables, charts, borders, margins.
Well, 131060 is the number. Tell us somebody now we haven't thought about for a while.
Yeah.
And on the other side of this, you've got the chance to walk away.
Timber sports hat.
With a Still Timber Sports
hat.
Kiss My Axe hat.
Yep. And if you name someone that's very, very popular currently, but we haven't thought about, you get the rule.
It's been a while since I've thought about Deirdre Brummer. Yeah. It's been a while since I've seen them.
Yep, I haven't thought about Deirdre. Who else? Yeah, good point. Haven't thought about Deirdre Brummer since he was in...
It was a cop show, wasn't it? Was he in an Underbelly?
Underbelly 2.
That's ages.
That's.
I've certainly won.
Yeah, absolutely. And give that's how this game works. You give me a yes.
Hamish just won a hat, everyone.
No, you can't win internally.
I'm donating it back.
Terms and conditions.
Oh, Ando, come on. We have enough hats. We've got so many hats now after we asked for hats.
Stephen, 131060 is the number.
Steve, you'd be pretty pumped here, mate.
Yeah, feeling good.
Tell us somebody what you haven't thought about for a while.
Avril Lavigne.
No, sorry, my friend.
I wouldn't have...
Hey, the other day, Josh, our friend, was on the show and said Avril Lavigne was in the photo.
Forgot about that.
He was actually broadcast. The word was broadcast.
Steve, I was with you for a bit. It seemed like someone I would have thought about, but I couldn't nail the exact time I had. But Andy, unfortunately, has pulled out some evidence that
I shouldn't have changed who I had then.
Who'd you have? Who'd you have, Steve?
Kylie Minogue.
Thought about her. Yeah, thought about her the other week because
she's gay.
Trademarking her name.
Yeah.
Anyone else? For a hat trick,
Steve.
Just what a hat. Just give us a hat.
Just blonde pop stars is Stephen's thoughts, but unfortunately, Steve, no hat.
Steve, we think about them too much. Steve, next Wednesday, give it a crack. Yeah. Please join us again. Adrian, ahoy.
Was I a bit too harsh on Steve coming straight in?
No, not at all. Adrian, sorry, how are you?
All right, thanks yourself.
Yeah, good, Adrian.
Very good, Adrian. This is for your chance to win a hat.
Yep.
There's now certainly plenty of hats in play. In fact, we didn't have to give one to Stephen Helps.
Yep.
Adrian, who haven't we thought about for a while?
John Howard, the actor from Blue Heelers.
Very good. I'm going to give it. I haven't. You think about him, Ando.
Again, Em.
Why do we think about it?
We got thrown around the other day when we were talking about possible actors.
Oh, yeah. Actors for someone's life.
Yes. Unfortunately, Adrian, I can't give it to you.
I think, Adrian, what I'm...
All good.
Sorry, Adrian. I love a man that appreciates and knows the rules. But yeah, you know what? I think because when someone mentioned it the other day, I was like, geez, I haven't thought of him for a while. And I'm remembering thinking I hadn't thought of him for a while. But I did think of him.
Sorry. But it's a tough game. I think about celebrities a lot.
It's a hard game. They
aren't necessarily...
On the radar.
Yeah. Louise.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy to you,
ahoy,
Louise.
Ahoy, Louise. This is for a hat. So far, the audience is hatless at this stage.
I'm pretty confident.
Okay, who haven't we thought about for a while?
Roseanne from that TV show.
Oh, I just read. There's a book by Judd Apatow, and she's interviewed in it. I was just reading it.
Well done, because that would have got me. We can't give out half hats, unfortunately.
God, I mean, if you were listening last week, guys, we were just giving out hats galore. It was an absolute hat shower. Emmett.
Hey, guys.
Emmett, how are you?
Who haven't we thought about for a while?
I did actually have a character, but I've got a person as well. But the character you wouldn't have thought of, but I'll save that in case this one fails. Okay. Oh, I thought Emilio Estevez.
I haven't thought of him for a while, you've got it, Emmett. Really well done, of course.
What I was going to say, Falcor, the dragon from... Never-Ending Story.
Falcor from Never-Ending Story would have also been...
Hey, Emmett, you've got two hats, mate.
Oh, and you know what? I'm a tree lover as well.
You're a tree lover!
Don't tell me you use steel-branded axes and power chainsaws.
Yes.
Here's a sponsor's hat coming your way.
Emmett, thank you very much. Well done, Sharon.
Hi.
Hot off the heels of a double hat giveaway.
Huge.
We must stress, though, you're only allowed one. I don't know how Emmett snuck in a couple of tries.
He was on a good roll. Yeah, he was on a streak.
He intrigued us by teasing the character.
He did well.
Yeah.
Hey, Sharon, who haven't we thought about for a while?
Ricky Lake, the talk show lady.
Gee, that's pretty good.
That's very good. Yeah.
I think about Oprah daily, but not Lake. Sharon.
Been on for a while.
Yeah, well done.
Yeah.
Well done. You got a hat. You a big Timber sports fan?
Evidently, Sharon,
you'd be loving it. Are you going to the Kiss My Axe Festival, Sharon?
No, but my dad probably would enjoy the hat.
Well, he's got the hat to wear to the festival.
Thanks, Sharon.
Thank you, Sharon.
Got a new game. Stephen got an opener. We'll do that now, Ham, because it's an interactive opener, and you reckon you've got someone.
Well, the game is, tell us someone we wouldn't have thought of in a while, and I will sing during the opener. I reckon I'll get some points for this.
Okay.
It's been a while since I've thought
about the Chilean miners.
Yeah.
Not bad.
It's been a while since I've seen them.
Definitely been a while since I thought about the Chilean miners that got caught underground.
And they captured the world's attention. Yeah. And yet, we haven't thought about them for a while, have we?
Yeah.
Can you honestly say?
No, but I'm worried that we're going to start going into Stewie Diver kind of territory.
It doesn't just have to be trapped people.
But they do have their time in the sun.
Amazing story. I mean, that's the thing. Yeah,
Douglas Wood would be the other one.
We can't classify them just based on their fame.
I feel real sorry for anyone who's coming in with a disaster-based celebrity.
Because now we're thinking all of them. I've thought of all of them. But Chilean miners, I mean, they were front page news for weeks.
Yeah.
And then whooshka, gone.
So the way this works is you got a chance to win a hat. We encourage businesses to send in the hat. Who have we got this week, Hem?
And it's certainly unknown to me, but now known to me, which sort of fits for the segment, for the theory of the segment. Physio cream. I guess it's like a pain relieving cream for sports people to rub into their aches and pains.
Just having a look at the hats, seem like worse quality than the hats last week.
Oh, well, it's not have a go at physio cream. I feel like they're just starting off as a company.
Okay.
I feel like they rang up a hat company and said, here's our logo with one colour and no tricks.
Yeah.
Just embroider our logo on a hat. We don't need anything special. We can't, and we got a visor.
Oh, sorry. I hadn't seen the visor. Sorry.
And look, physio cream, the visor has three colours.
Yeah. Okay. That's impressive. So you want the visor.
We can't compare a starting out health cream company to the Red Bull Formula One racing team, which was the first hats we gave away. You can't. I mean there's $100 million marketing difference.
I understand, but people deserve to know what they're playing for.
True. It's it's a basic fabric bottom rung promotional hat. probably were expensive now in physio cribs while you're tearing their bloody hair out.
Starting this off is Serge. Serge, tell us someone you think we haven't thought of for a while.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Serge, and good luck.
Look, Fran Drescher from The Nanny.
Sorry, mate.
Oh, wow. How often do you think about Fran?
Fran, she's a Trump supporter. She's in the press this week.
Yeah, I missed that.
Sorry, Sergey.
Sorry, Serge. No, maybe you saw that, and that's why you were thinking of Fran.
No, physio creme visor for you.
No choice between hat or visor for you. Matt.
Yep.
Ahoy.
Ahoy, boys.
Oh, there's a bit of swagger about Matt.
Confident, Matty?
Just a little.
Okay. If you do win, are you going to go visor or hat?
Definitely going to go the visor.
Yeah, good.
Although a bit subpar with it. I mean, what kind of brand is it? What have we got?
Physio cream.
We don't know. We just ask people to send hats in, and then that gives us the prize. So, yeah, we don't know. Your guess is as good as ours, mate.
But I would advise
you to go to the visor.
I'll take a visor.
Yep. Well, yeah, you can't take one yet, friend. Who have we not thought about for a while?
You haven't thought about Don Burke from Burke's Backyard.
I have.
Oh, really? Oh,
yes. So sorry, Matt.
Why have you thought about him?
Because he owns racehorses.
Yep.
And there's footage, there's video of one of our mates at a stud farm where the horse was getting randy and they were getting a sample from the horse. And then someone goes, and by the way, that's Don Burke's horse. So unlucky, but I watched a footy of Don Burke's horse getting randy just a couple of weeks ago.
Unlucky, Matt.
Sorry, Matt.
No hat or visor has been given away.
I'll send you the video if you don't believe me.
Yeah. Tony joins us.
Ahoy.
Ahoy, Tone.
Tell us someone we haven't thought about for a while.
I'm thinking of Christina Applegate.
No, unfortunately not.
I think we might have used her as an example for this game.
And she's also in Anchorman too.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
So, oh, my God. And she's my screensaver.
Yeah. Oh. So sorry. Sorry, Tony. Yeah, Anchorman 2 is being advertised at the moment.
Yep.
It's a no deal. So we haven't got
sorry, Tony. Yep. It does have to be both Annie and I not having thought about the person for a while. Jordan.
Hello.
Ahoy, hey, Jordan. Try your luck for a hat or a visor.
Shania Twain.
I don't.
We said this year, didn't we?
Yeah, I have
she
watched.
She sings, it doesn't impress me much, doesn't it? Yeah, sorry, mate.
Oh.
And the reason why I say this, and this is unfortunate for Jordan, but the second New Year's, well, it's the second day after New Year's Eve.
You listen to it on New Year's Day.
The 2nd of January, I messed up at home, and Beck put on that don't impress me much. And danced around and waved her finger.
Would have been this year. And I also watched a documentary on Lance Armstrong. Yeah. Now, I can't remember if he was married to Shania Twain or Sheryl Crow.
Sheryl Crow.
But I never can tell the difference. And so I thought about both of them. I would have thought about both of them.
Okay.
So I don't remember specifically thinking about it.
I took a video on January 2nd of Jack Beck dancing.
It's an honesty system. Yeah. John, really unlucky for everyone today.
That's why I was so close.
Dave, how are you feeling?
Ahoy, boys.
Yeah, ahoy, Dave. And then you'd have to be nervous because seems like we have thought about a lot of people.
I'm confident, but I am wary of the half equaling a non-win.
Yes, yeah, good. Yep, You're aware of the rules.
Good luck.
One of the better players.
Who have we not thought about, Dave?
I have an inkling. You haven't thought about the now forgotten Korean artist of Gangnam Style, Psy.
I can't say I have, Ando. I don't have any evidence coming to mind that I would have thought about Psy.
I'm so sorry.
Did you think about Psy?
Mate, we thought about him together.
When?
When we were laughing at another radio station for always doing song parodies.
Yeah, we sung.
Every song parody that they do is always, for some reason,
just about the Aussie version of something.
Something, and they did Aussie battler style.
Yeah, which was very funny, by the way.
Exactly.
I'm not going to have a go at the creative integrity of that song. Probably their biggest hit.
Yes, exactly.
And they are good friends of ours. But they did do that song. Sorry, David. Nick, we'll keep going. Yeah. We'll keep going until we get a win at Nick. Who haven't we thought about?
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy. Who do you reckon?
I'm thinking Mark Philippoussis.
Yeah, I haven't thought of him for ages.
I haven't thought of the poo. Yeah, oh, Nick, we're not just saying that so you get a hat or a visor, but you got one.
Thanks, guys. Woo!
All right, what do you want? You got a black hat, purple hat, or a white visor?
Oh, a black hat sounds pretty good, I think.
Yep. Yeah, well, very good choice.
Very good. Coming into winter, nice little black hat for you.
Same as Shanetti driving you home.
Time for... It's been a while
since I've thought of Christina Ricci.
Yeah. And it's been a while since
I've seen them. Yeah, probably.
Who else?
Last saw on a Adams Family.
That's what I was thinking. Is it Ricci or Ricky? Doesn't matter. Yeah. Doesn't matter. We know who you mean. And that's the game. Ando, you get a hat. Because I have not thought in Christina Ricci / Ricky for a while. And that's the game. Mm. 13-10-60, who haven't we thought of in a while?
Yes.
For a while. We usually categorize it as all year.
Yeah. I still think we should go just this year. I still think we're in the first year, but I suppose when we hit, what do you reckon, June? Is that when we're going
to
start
That's
going?
That's when we have to creep back into, like, you know, since Feb, since March.
Okay.
It'll be starting to be a bit
have
mean.
Have we thought of these people this year? Ham, what hat's up for grabs? We always ask people to...
Before I get to the hat, can I tell you, we got a great one last week from our mate Josh, who just texted in just after the game finished, and he had a cracker. Steve, the security guard from Jerry Springer. Like, that is right in the slot. Yeah. I was tempted to give him two hats offline just because Jerry Springer would also probably count.
Yeah, I know. Probably haven't thought of Jerry, but yeah, let alone Steve.
Now that I'm thinking of Jerry, though, I'm thinking of Ricky Lake. I'm thinking of, so don't call with anyone in that category.
Yeah, exactly.
Because that would be...
Daytime television stars are all flying around my head at the moment. So
now if you called up with one of those people, we'd have to say, look, we just discussed Jerry Springer.
Yeah.
Phil Donahue.
Think of Sally Jesse Raphael.
There, she's in that camp. Can I throw one at you that I had the other day, and I thought, I reckon I'd get a hat for this.
Okay.
Odie, the dog from Garfield.
Wow, Jack knew it. I didn't even know who Odie is. So I haven't thought of him.
You know who he is, though. He's this sort of lovable, kind of half nemesis of Garfield.
Never got into Garfield.
Me neither. Yeah. I thought it was a bit basic. Yeah. Far more Snoopy man. But
he's a Fred Bassett guy.
Very much a Fred Bassett guy when it comes to dog-based cartoons.
Hey, the hat, please.
Hat. Choice of, in case we have four winners, first three hats are from a company called Hangover Helpers.
Looks like a good quality hat as well. Trucker.
Oh, look at that. They're all different colours. Mm. I didn't notice that. A green hat, but the brand is written in a different colour.
Again, this is not a paid spot.
No. Honestly, it's the cheapest advertising rate. You sent us a hat?
Yep.
Could get a plug.
And what's the last one?
Sometimes it's not a positive plug.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know if Physio Cream, the hats that we talked about last time
were wrapped
because we really had a go at them for their app and had to be the first option in the merchandising hat pamphlet.
Yeah. It was a low, it was a budget hat.
It was a budget hat.
What's the other one?
Look at this. Stan hat.
Oh, Stan.
Well, we only had three Hangover Helper hats. Yeah. So Stan streaming service fitted. Sort of like
Flexi Fit?
Yeah. Look.
Oh, yeah. One of those Flexi Fit
ones. Like a new era
hat. It's a good hat. They're all
up for grabs. I don't know. I mean, they've gone for like a cool like...
Flat bim? Yeah. I don't think anyone's going to go for a flat bim kind of online television show provider hat and be regarded as two.
Dope lid, man. I also enjoy streaming on Stan.
But they're the four hats up for grabs. You get to choose 13-10-60. Tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
It's a tough game. Tougher than you think.
I'd be avoiding daytime American presenters.
Big time.
Big time at the moment.
Or other people that lived in Garfield's house.
Yes.
I'm thinking of John now.
Harrison, who haven't we thought about for a while?
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Harrison.
Jessica Watson.
Yeah, we haven't thought about her.
Have we?
Yeah.
Who is it?
Jessica.
Oh, the sailor.
She's the sailor.
Yeah, she's on the ANZAC. Sorry, I was thinking, who's in Murder, She Wrote?
Jessica Lambry.
Yep.
Oh, whatever.
Sorry, Harrison. She's on the ANZ ANZ.
Yes.
I've, and I know I've thought about her because they try and make it look like, you know, she's sailing. They've caught her sailing around the world.
Yeah.
On the ad.
And she's yelling to camera. She's yelling like to camera. Like flown a drone down to go, what do you think of banking? I don't know, but...
Oh, I've always got to be prepared. Never know when I need an ATM. I'm actually not allowed to have help. Anyway, ANZ. Yeah, sorry, Harrison. Sorry. She's on an ad. Yeah. Brandon, ahoy.
Ahoy, boys.
Who haven't we thought about for a while?
That girl who used to sing or did sing a song Friday, Rebecca Black.
Rebecca Black.
Yeah, okay.
That's a pass for me. I haven't thought about her for a while.
I don't think I have thought of her, Brandon.
You've got yourself a hat.
Brandon, well done.
Brandon, tell
it's
us.
It's a good category to play into, someone that has a bright, shining bright.
But now I'm thinking of them all.
Brandon, what do you want? The Hangover Helper, how the Stan one?
Oh, definitely the Hangover Helper for sure.
Great. Yeah, what colour? I got green, peach, or orange writing.
Oh, Jesus. Peach.
All right. Peach, yep. He's got a hat.
Yeah,
peach.
Well done, Brandon. That, good choice, that, actually. Now that I look at it, that's the best colour.
Jess, tell us someone you think we haven't thought about for a while.
Ahoy. I was thinking of Stephanie McIntosh.
Oh, my gosh. Such a wrong, bumped into her at the airport, Ham, on the way back.
Did you think about her when you bumped into her?
Well, I thought about her when she said, remember me. But Steph Mack bumped, we just flew back from overseas. Yes. I literally bumped into her. She wasn't even traveling. She was dropping off her sister to fly back because she's now lives there.
Jess, that is so unlucky because Steph Mack from Neighbours and the Steph Mack Show, short-lived on Channel 10 for those who remember it, is a wonderful guest and normally the kind of person that would absolutely guarantee you a hat in this game.
I didn't remember her. Sorry, when
but would she, you recommend
when, when she was talking to me for a bit? That's how good Jess's guess was.
Very good,
but just a week too late.
Okay, what a shame,
Emma.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Em.
I'm thinking Josh Hartnett.
Nah, sorry, I've thought of him.
No way. Yeah.
How have you thought of him?
Because 40 Days and 40 Nights, whatever the film
is?
Yes,
I've just watched that recently and I thought they haven't thought of him, surely.
Nah, Beck's got it taped on Foxtel. Foxtel IQ. And so when we're flicking through films, she's always recommending this one. Yeah, I don't know the film.
Good knowing that Hartnett was in 40 Days, 40 Nights.
Thanks.
All I know him from is Pearl Harbor. Do you see Pearl Harbor, Emma?
Yeah, seen Pearl Harbor. It's the other big one, but all good. No worries. Thanks, boys.
Sorry, Em. Back to the drawing board.
She respects the rules so well.
You'll get it.
Do we have time for one more?
Kayla. Ahoy, Kayla.
Ahoy, hoy.
Oh, who have we not thought about for a while?
Aaron Carter, Nick Carter's brother.
Yeah. Spent so little time thinking about him when he was relevant, I certainly haven't thought about him since.
Nick Carter's little brother. Yeah. Very good, because I have thought about Nick Carter. I was just checking the files to make sure that train of thought didn't lead onto his little brother, didn't. It didn't.
What hat would you like, Kayla?
What hat do you want?
You pick one for me.
I'm going to send you out I'll send you out the Stan hat, because then it's off our books.
Don't worry.
You're going to love it, Kayla.
Thank you, Kayla. Stick around, everybody. We're going to need your help, everyone. We need your help.
Do you know what?
Building a whole new segment.
I've only just thought of this, but we might actually make a hat as a prize.
For the
next segment.
Oh, yes. That's a great
idea. It just seems that hats are such good prizes, and you just heard on the phones that everyone wants a hat.
Yeah, exactly.
Why don't we make our own?
Same as Andy. It's been a while
since I've thought about Jean-Paul from Uni. It's been a while since I've seen him. Okay, now he doesn't qualify.
Yeah, he doesn't qualify, but yeah, I haven't. His name wasn't Jean-Paul either from Uni.
What was his name?
His name was Jean-Paul someone.
Yeah, but we just called him Jean-Paul.
Yeah.
He was a club promoter.
Yeah.
A little personal curveball for Ando there, just a little bit of an inside pitch, because the game we're playing is still something we haven't thought about for a while. It does need to be a household name.
Yeah, celebrity. And look, Jean-Paul was big in our circles, but not big enough break it nationally.
He was revered.
Thought. Yeah.
Like, you know, buddy up to Jean-Paul, get some drink cards. Yeah. Not the game. Yeah. But thanks for indulging me. I just wanted to see your face as I said, Jean-Paul.
I think it was an immediate shake.
You've never seen him more disappointed. And that is saying something. So the game is still something we haven't thought about in a while. The rule being If we've thought about this celebrity this year, unfortunately, you lose. But if you name a household name we haven't thought about in a while and we give it to you, you've won yourself a hat. The first hat to go is from a company called huntcatchcook.com. It's got an inbuilt bottle opener on the on the peak. Cool. Huge win. It's what you want. Claudia, how are you?
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Claude.
You're this close to getting a good hat.
Oh, I think I'm pretty close, yeah.
Okay. All right, who have you got? Who haven't we thought about in a while?
Brendan Fraser.
Sorry. No.
The Mummy? No, yeah.
No. No, we've thought about him. We went through actually all his films just recently.
Did we?
Yeah, no, I went. Actually, I remember it was with Beck, but we're talking about Brendan Fraser because I was explaining to her who Paulie Shaw was.
Okay, yep.
Had the long hair and obviously Encino Man.
It was Brendan Fraser's breakout film. Claudia, a valiant effort. Yep. Unfortunately, real air ball. Jordan, ahoy. And,
ahoy, boys.
Yep. Mate, who haven't we thought about for a while?
Australian athlete Steve Hooker, the pole vaulter.
Unfortunately.
Jeez, we were actually talking about him the other day.
We're talking about him the other day.
Sorry.
Yes. Probably when we're covering up curly head people, I suppose. We've gone through Paulie Shaw and then I've gone on to Steve Hooker.
No, we were talking about how difficult it would be to pole vault.
Yeah.
And then we were saying, you know, if you were Steve Hooker, how high would you be pole vaulting? Because we were guessing, you know.
We're vaulting
records. You weren't to know it, Jordan, and it's unlucky.
We're wondering what would the handicap be if Hamish and I had no training against Steve Hooker.
To pole vault. You're not to know this, Jordan, but we talk about this a lot. We actually talk about Olympic sports a lot and the handicap we would need to compete in the sport. Yep. And it was decided that there's no handicap really available for pole vault because you can either do it or you can't.
And the pole, we thought, did the pole go backwards or forwards? Because...
What do you mean?
Our pole would always be longer than the bar, and I don't think that happens in...
Mate, we couldn't do it. We wouldn't be able to get off the ground. That's where the conversation ended up. We need a ladder, and we just walk up slowly, put the ladder up, climb up, jump over.
Jack.
Hi there.
Jack, mate.
Ahoy, I should say.
Hey,
ahoy
to you, it's up to you if you use the preferred telephonic greeting, but we always appreciate it. Ahoy, Jack.
Tell us someone we haven't thought about for a while.
Sophie Ellis-Bextor.
That's true.
Sophie Ellis-Bextor, Murder on the Dance Floor?
I haven't heard it yet.
I don't think I've thought of Sophie Ellis-Bextor.
Well done. Well done.
Jack, it's your lucky day. You've got the huntcatchcook.com hat with the inbuilt bottle opener. Hang on a sec. What's this?
Hang on.
I know, Jack. Right at the last.
We're going to have to review the tape.
Have we had her before on this segment?
I just wonder whether I sung her the very first time we played it with the opener. I wonder whether I sung Sophie Ellis-Bextor.
Jack,
do you remember? Jack.
Sorry, we've got Jack on the phone.
You've got the win.
Has he got the hat?
But he's got, unless we can work out that. So some people, our producing team can go through and see if they can pull that up.
Jack, on the phone, how do you feel about this? Your hat has been put into trust until...
I don't know how I feel about it, guys. Can I still keep listening to you guys after this?
Yeah, I know. Well, your phone's blowing up. We can hear it buzzing. But here's the thing, Jack. I mean,
I feel like I may have sung it.
Yep.
Jack's starting to think now. I feel like I may have sung it during this game in the opener.
The ethical question we now face is, we all said, yes, you've got it. Mm. But what if we produce evidence that, of course, we have thought of her in a while because Andy sung that song a few weeks ago. Mm. Are we still legally obliged to give away that hat?
No.
Or have we overruled
We'd
the
have
win?
To overrule.
Jack, on the phone, how do you feel about that?
Well, evidence is evidence, guys. I won't hold it.
Yeah, okay. Well, let's see if we can track it down. If we can't,
it's all yours, Jack.
So Jack stands by. We move on to Megan.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Megan.
Sorry about that. Bit of a real legal kerfuffle there. Yep. Who haven't we thought about for a while?
Shannon Doherty.
We've had her come up. But didn't we have her come up already in this segment?
Yeah, I mean, I have thought about it, but I don't think, I've absolutely thought about it. We thought of all the non-essentials.
Do you know what? Yeah. I thought of Shannon Doherty for Scare Tactics, Megan, which is the show she hosted, because remember those guys, the Jalal guys, who got in trouble for that prank, and one of their defences was going, oh, mate, Scare Tactics was a huge show. Nobody's having a go at them.
Yeah.
And my response was, but that was just pretending he's a little man that's a rat man in a disused science lab and Shannon Doherty being there. So, unfortunately, I did think of her.
Shannon Doherty, that's right, you did.
In context to the defence that Jalal's used.
Megan, but moving on to Daniel. She did take it well, Ham.
You took it well, Megan.
Daniel, tell us something we haven't thought of for a while.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Dan.
All right, Yahoo Serious. We haven't heard of him for a while.
I haven't thought of him. Sorry.
Well, you have.
Yeah, I've thought of him. I thought
of him. Oh, yeah. No. Yeah. Sorry, Dan. I thought you were absolutely clear on goal there. And now, Andy's...
Beck and I saw him.
What?
Up in Palm Beach.
Stan, I can't
North
beat
of Sydney.
I can't beat. I know Palm Beach. I mean, I can't. I can't beat in the flesh sighting. Dan, how do you feel?
Oh yeah, all right.
Yeah. you're only playing for physio cream hat.
Daniel, thank you, but I'm afraid.
When did you see him?
Well, you know, when I took back up to
a couple months ago.
Yeah, up to the North
yep,
Shores.
Yep. All right, yeah.
Faith.
Faith, ahoy.
Geez, ahoy there.
A really tension-filled game today. Mm. Faith, who haven't we thought about in a while?
I don't think you've heard of Cyndi Lauper.
Cyndi Lauper. It's a good for me. I haven't thought of Cyndi Lauper for a long time.
This is where my brain goes, well, I know who that is. Mm. But then when I ask my brain, oh, yeah, hot shot? Well, when'd you think about her? It can't give me a solid date this year.
Yep.
Faith, you've got it.
You got a hat.
You've got a hat.
A hat, Faith.
Faith.
Now, because a few callers ago, Jack already won the hat with the bottle opener in the cat, you've got your choice between Delta Force Paintball and Physio Cream, a recurring kind of dud hat that's been
Which one are you gonna
in
go
the
for?
Box for a while. What do you want, Faith?
I think we're going to have to go with the paintball.
Yeah, good idea. Fantastic idea.
Thanks, Queen Jackpots. The hat jackpots. All right, well, we're going to go to a song today.
We'll work it out for Jack.
We'll come back to him later in the show and we'll give our official ruling.
Time to play.
It's been a while since I've thought
of Kimberly Davies. Yeah.
Yeah. And it's been a while since I've seen them.
From Neighbours, yeah?
Yeah.
Who else?
Probably. Yeah, good question, Ham. Probably, I'd say late '90s.
Late '90s. Yep.
Yep.
I had a mate that had a poster of her, and I'm just dating it back to about year 11. I would have seen that on his wall.
She was
terrific actress.
Terrific actress. And great at posters.
Yeah, no, certainly had a poster period that she excelled in. good on you, Pete. Wonder if you've still got it. No, great one, Ando. Haven't thought of her. This is, tell us someone we haven't thought about for a while.
Yes.
You would have won a hat then, Ando, but you can't win a hat because you're ineligible. Can you ring up on 131060 and tell us someone we haven't thought about in a while? We still define a while as this year.
If your company has a hat, just send them in. You might be lucky enough to be the winning hat today.
Gee, we got Ando. Yeah. Jeez, you wouldn't mind a few of these.
Yeah. MacPack.
MacPack hats.
Yeah, nice. Flexi fit? No.
No. One of those fancy brass adjustable fabric straps at the back. I know that probably costs more. My least favourite kind of hat, but still, that's a nice hat.
I would say that hat is the preferred clasp mechanism for those over 35.
And this is a hat for a gent that would like to think that he's got what it takes to face sort of the extreme conditions of an icy mountain where with like crampons and an ice axe. Mm. But this is the hat he casually wears on a spring walk.
Yes,
this isn't his ascent hat, but it's the one he wears just to keep his sponsor happy. When we run out of those, who's this?
Oh, physio creme.
The booby hat. the world's leading...
Velcro backing.
Very, very cheap.
Pretty generic type embroidery.
We really appreciate Physio Creme
sending in
the hats. They send a lot.
Put a lot of their technology.
Still trying to clean them out of the system. So, 131060.
A lot of their money went into the technology behind Physio Creme and certainly not the hats.
Wonderful creme.
The creme to the creme. Anyway, 131060. Call up now.
You really look like the cat that got the physio creme, by which I mean, all your aches and pains are gone and you seem to be moving smoothly.
131060 is the number. All you have to do is ring up for your chance to win one of these two hats today. Tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while, and that is this year. If we can state, yes, we have thought of those people in this year.
Sadly, no hat.
In the middle of tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
Look, we should point out at this stage, we've been doing this game now for a few weeks and people are really getting the hang of it. Yep. We still have some people that are going for, no offence, really low-hanging fruit. Nikki Webster, of course we've thought of her.
Yeah.
I mean, she's the go-to for someone you haven't thought of in a while, and that's why we're always thinking of her. Yep. Corey Worthington.
Yep.
Ditto.
Yep.
The one-hit, you know, your Steve Urkels and stuff. Mm. They're the people we're always thinking of. Yep.
Anyone you have seen on a news-based program of Where Are They Now? They're their favourites.
They're the favourites.
I probably thought of them.
But in a way, they're famous for not being thought of, and that makes them famous.
Yeah.
Who else? Who are we missing?
Jody wanted to crack at the title. Jody, ahoy.
Ahoy, boys. How
ahoy
to you,
Jody. Now, you've heard this segment before.
Have.
Now, did you come up with your person?
I did. I've been thinking about it.
Yeah, because we get a lot of people. We had someone like, you know, we get a lot of people going, oh, I've been trying to call for weeks. Yeah. I've got someone. I think it's a lock. Yeah. Who have you got, Jud?
Heather Locklear.
Oh, sorry.
Oh,
really?
Yeah, no, I saw David Spade when I was...
thought of Heather Locklear from
the fact that he dated her.
Oh, he dated her, didn't he?
Back when I was referred to as the David Spade of Australia for a while, which hurt me when I started dating me.
Generous?
No, not for any comedy now. It's just the fact that
I think David Spade's a pretty good-looking guy.
No, he's not, mate. But sorry, Jody, no. Unfortunately... Heather Locklear has been in my mind.
Yeah. Oh, well, Michael. And I know she was a favourite of yours too growing up.
Yes.
So she's sort of always there for when you go to sleep. A lot of people don't know this, but I've stayed in caravans and stuff with Andy for years now, and he'll go to sleep and go, night, good night, good night, good night. And he tells you, he says, oh, I've got a team of, you know, like 50 girls that say good night to me in my mind, like famous ones from throughout history.
Not true at all. Michael, let's play on.
So you don't want to name one of the 50, Mike.
ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Mike. Ahoy. Who haven't we thought of for a while?
I reckon I've got you. I reckon Lucy Liu.
No.
Oh.
Charlie's Angels.
Yeah, I mean, no, because there's a restaurant called Lucy Liu's.
Oh, that's true. We've been just recently.
You just,
yeah,
you know, how can you not think of Lucy Liu, Mike, if you go to a restaurant called Lucy Liu's?
Fair enough.
Yeah, and Charlie's Angels on high rotation on your Foxtels.
I haven't run into Charlie and his Angels for a bit.
Okay.
But I think the restaurant clears us there. Keeps the hat in our hands.
Adam, your chance to win a hat that's been sent in from a company. Please do send in more hats. Adam.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Adam. Who you got?
I got Coney from Coney 2012.
Oh, that's good.
That is fantastic.
Clear from my end. Clear from my end.
You know it's a good one.
I haven't thought of him since that campaign worked and we caught him. We caught him at the end of 2012 and everyone
No one gave a crud.
That's it, everyone.
Well done.
Good one, Adam.
Self-centered there, Adam.
Don't have to take the hat away for saucy language. But Adam, what do you want? Do you want the Mac Pack hat?
I recommend.
Wink, wink, wink. Yep. Recommended. Or physio creme?
I think I go with the Mac Pack.
Oh, yes. Well done.
Good pick, Adam.
Fantastic, Adam. That was great. You know it's a good one when someone says Coney, like he said, and I went, who the hell's he talking about? Oh,
boom,
that guy, yes.
A flood of memories comes back. And that's exactly what we play the game for. Anthony, for a chance to also scoop one of the hats on offer.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Anthony. Tell us some. Yeah, really good, mate. An excellent serve. An ace from Adam. Who have you
Martin
got?
Martin Lawrence from Bad Boys 2.
I watched Bad Boys 2 weeks ago.
And Hamish and I were talking about how it still stands up as one of the best action movies of all time.
Oh, all time. All time.
I mean, the bit where Martin goes, you know, and some Skittles. I mean, that's, you know, the bit I'm talking about, Ant?
Which one's better, number one or two?
I think one.
Really? Okay.
So, Anthony, interesting you say this, but Alex, who used to edit on our show, the American guy, used to edit on Gap Year, thinks Bad Boys 2 is the best action film of all time and employs
I do agree. And number two is a bit better.
He's asking everyone to go and reconsider.
I just have such fond memories from number one.
Have you seen two?
I think I have. Isn't that at the end they're on the tarmac with the plane?
No.
Is that one? I mean, no one's enjoying this conversation.
Least
of all me. No one's driving along in the car going, this should be a podcast.
Yes.
Try and remember films you might not have seen.
We're in the middle of playing.
It's been a while. Since I've thought
about the samurai pizza cats.
Good.
Yeah, and it's been a while since I've seen them.
It's a mid-90s. Look, it was kind of up there with the Ninja Turtles, wasn't it? Samurai pizza cats.
No, it wasn't up there, but it was on.
Around at the same time.
Yep. But now that you look at it through critical adult eyes, you do wonder where the samurai pizza cats got their inspiration from, since the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles who loved pizza
we're doing
were
well.
Around at the same time.
Megan joins us for a chance to win a hat of her choosing. We can tell her which hat we think would be the better one.
Megan, how are you?
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, boys. Megan, and welcome to the show. Certainly from where we sit, the Australian National Baseball Team hat, the Southern Thunder cap, looks great. You know, there's been some talk in the studio that, is it too good? Have we put too much money into the hat quality of our baseball team and not enough into recruiting, was Jack's worry. Our response to Jack was, for God's sake, man, baseball invented a hat style.
Yes.
You have to have a good hat if you're a baseball team. Could be yours, Megan. Tell us
Thank you.
We haven't thought about in a while.
Okay, I thought long and hard about this one. Macy Gray.
Oh, yes.
Good.
And just like that, you have absolutely nailed it. Not a lot of people have thought about Macy Gray in a while. Even some of her friends listening to this who go, geez, I must call Macy. I meant to catch her with her for Christmas and I bloody forgot. But same with Nora Jones.
Now, Megan,
you've got a huge Grammy winner.
Obviously.
Obviously,
we were talking about the Australian baseball hat being the best. There's also an SBS Eurovision hat, hashtag Damiami, or could go the physio.
Well, you've talked up that baseball hat.
Yep, it's all yours.
Megan, you're going to look great. You're going to look great in it.
Wendy joined us now. Congratulations, Megan. Huge. We only normally have one or none
that was
winners.
Yeah, that was really
so
good.
So it's nice to come out of the blocks with one. Wendy, tell us someone we haven't thought about for a while.
I'm hoping I'm your second winner. I don't think you've thought about Miss Wendy from Don't Forget Your Toothbrush.
Sorry.
Oh, no, Wendy. Andy thinks and talks about Don't Miss Forget Wendy. Your Toothbrush quite a lot. I believe Miss Wendy was one of his first crushes.
Yep. Miss Wendy.
Aww.
Yeah.
Sorry,
Wendy. Can I do a second one?
Sorry, Wendy.
This isn't actually Miss Wendy, is it?
Yes, it is.
You so actually are. Are you Miss Wendy?
maybe.
Okay. Well, now you've really, I mean, Andy's childhood crush there. I mean, he's.
I would just love that Eurovision hat.
Yeah, no, you duped me into thinking you're my childhood crush. You can't have it.
Andy's probably on the verge of banning you for life, Wendy, although you're always welcome to call me up personally.
Bad luck.
No,
Wendy.
Bad luck, Wendy.
Brett.
There we go.
Ahoy, Brett.
Brett, were you old enough to remember Miss Wendy from the TV show Don't Forget Your Toothbrush?
No idea who you're talking about.
Yeah,
do yourself
me
a favor
neither,
and
Brett.
Google,
neither. And I was old enough, but Andy is relentlessly banging on about it. But we move.
She was great, Brett. Still is, probably.
Okay. Brett, tell us someone we haven't thought about for a while.
Axel Whitehead.
Oh. Nah, I've got him in the barrel. In fact, I bumped into him.
Oh, boy.
Around about 4 months ago.
Jeez, that's unlucky.
That was the only thing I was afraid of.
Yeah. The only thing.
Well, your worst nightmares coming true before your very ears,
hey,
Brett.
He was at the cafe around the corner from work here. It was an accidental bump hit. Yeah, I didn't meet up with him, and he was there with a music producer talking about an upcoming album.
Really?
Yes. There's a scoop. If anyone cares.
Well, keep your eye out for Loose Nut Axel's upcoming album.
Sorry, Brett. Yep, I've definitely thought about him. Aaron?
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Aaron.
Tell us someone we haven't thought about in a while.
I believe you wouldn't have heard about or thought of Ernie Sigley.
I don't think I've thought of Ernie Sigley, Aaron. I think you've got that.
Yeah, you got that. Well,
you've got it, Aaron.
Can you remind everybody who Ernie Sigley is, Aaron?
He was on what was he on the morning show with Denise Drysdale?
Yep.
It's a good one. It's a really good one, because if you've said Ding Dong, no chance. Everyone's thinking about Denise a lot.
Yes.
But Ernie Sigley has flown under our radar and stayed off our radar.
Aaron, would you like the SBS hat or the physio creme?
I think I'll have to go to the SBS.
Yeah, it's better quality.
Smart choice. Look, we've got one more in the barrel here.
It's a chance to give away physio creme.
The good news for Dan is you've got a chance to win a hat. The bad news is it's the physio creme hat, which usually jackpots from week to week as the booby prize. Ahoy, Dan.
Ahoy, boys.
Dan, even though it's just the physio creme up for grabs, would you like to hang up now and save your guest and try and get through next week? Or do you want to have a crack for the physio creme hat?
No, I'm going to get that hat.
Good man.
Okay.
Good man.
Good luck, Dan.
Tell us someone we haven't thought about for a while.
Righto. Vanessa Amorosi.
No, sorry. She's on the list. She's regularly thought about.
She's regularly thought about.
I'm so sorry, Dan.
Yep, she had performed at a number of our parties back in the day.
She supported Frank Stallone. Her name actually came up the other day when we were talking about the Logie Spit Roast Party. So, yep. Dan, you weren't to know. You can't have known.
And you can't have the physio creme hat.
But the good news is your head remains physio creme hatless.
Time for... It's been a while since I've thought about Tatiana Grigorieva.
Good. Yeah, and it's been a while since I've seen them. Risky one, though.
Why?
Olympic year.
It's probably why I thought of her now, but... Yeah, I mean, pole vaulter. She was on Dancing with the Stars as well, I think.
She's very risky. But you've done it. You've got one
through.
You
didn't actually get by me if I was pumped.
Oh, good, Jack. No, dude, block it. When Jack, did you think about Tatiana?
I actually met a Tatiana at a dog park this week. And I go, you don't hear that name often since Tatiana
Grigorieva.
And if you've just tuned in for the first time, what you're hearing is the exact game in motion of tell us someone we haven't thought about in a while. If you ring up and you can name someone that we haven't thought of this year, you will win yourself a hat. However, if we can tell you that we have thought of that person and explain the circumstances in which we thought of them, sadly, you'll be barred from the hat.
Great example, Jack, of the kind of response we might give if we have heard of them. We have to really isolate the time now, and have a convincing case.
As we said at the start of the show, by far the most... disappointed amount of players per game
that we have
on this show.
That win, yep.
Because people ring up and you think you've got an absolute slam dunk, but you just don't know who we've thought of this year.
Hang the hats.
All right.
What hats are up for grabs? We ask companies to send in hats so we can give them away.
This is what you covet. Yep. Guinness have sent us some leftover hats from St. Patrick's Day.
What do you think, quality-wise?
Not great. although I don't mind, if you're going to do a snapback, at least do a snapback. Don't do the Velcro.
Yes.
So I appreciate that, Guinness.
Snapback hat, just the plugging at the
back. Look, if you're into Guinness, you'd bloody love that hat. My dad would get right into that. Here's a good one. This, now we're talking. Little Aths Australia.
Great.
Sponsored by Jetstar, funnily enough. Orange hat. Yeah. Sponsors of the show, sponsors of Little Aths.
Is it a smaller hat?
It's a child's hat. Great. So if you've got a kid, if you've got a little athletics aged child, or a friend who's got the size of a child's head, you'd probably pick this hat.
It looks the best, doesn't it?
It's a sports hat. You've got ventilation on the side there for sweaty child heads. You got a nice, thick front to protect the front of your head and your vital forehead area from the wind. Yep. You got a great peak for sun protection. It does have Velcro at the back. I'll let that slide
because it's
a sports hat.
And for kids.
And for kids, they can't get their fingers caught.
That ain't the last hat. The last hat.
Absolute worst home shopping channel of all time. The last hat. Well, well, well. Look who's crept out of the dungeon.
Physio creme.
The world's leading pain relieving creme. And worst hat. The purple physio creme hat. Now, the logo for physio creme is just basically Arial font, and it's FISIO.
Yep. It's on the front.
CREM. Trademarked. Oh, don't worry, guys. Yeah. No one's stealing it.
Probably your cheapest embroidery you can get.
Very, very basic embroidery. They've ticked the first box on the promotional hat form. And the logo is an arrow leaping out from the middle of the logo to the end, which is,
pointing at the TM.
Pointing at the trademark. So they really want you to know that physio creme is trademarked. I sort of interpreted that arrow as an arc a hat might make flying through the air into a bin.
Anyway, that's up for grabs if you choose it as well.
You do. Thank you, though, to Physio Creme. You sent it in ages ago. I think fair is fair. We have talked about you guys every single week for the cost of a hat. Bloody good creme.
We play.
Bloody bad hat.
About to play Tell Us Someone We Haven't Thought About for a While. The way this game works is you call up, you list a famous person or a character.
Yep.
If we haven't thought about them for this year.
Yep.
You win yourself a hat. Three hats available today, Ham.
Three hats for grabs. Eli, ahoy and welcome.
Ahoy, hoy, Hamish and Andy.
Ahoy, Eli.
Feeling confident with your selection, Eli?
Not really.
You don't know with this game, do you?
Yeah, it's pretty unpredictable, and I just thought maybe I'll give it a shot. I'm not really keen on the hat, though, because I don't wear hats.
That's all right. Give it away, mate.
It's more of a trophy.
It's a trophy.
And there's nothing. You can't actually do anything with an Oscar statuette, but it's still nice to have one.
Yeah, exactly. Hang it on the wall.
Eli, who you got? Fire away.
Well, Afro Man.
Oh,
I don't.
The singer.
I don't know.
Yeah,
who that
the
is.
Rapper.
The rapper.
Because I Got High. He sings.
Yep.
Wow.
That's
yeah,
all
we, well, he's, I got, yeah, he's got it. He's got it for me.
Yeah, yeah. I mean.
Yeah.
I think I've got to give it to you.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
What I'm going through here are those emotions of going, I do know who that is. Yeah. And my brain's going, you must have thought of him.
Yeah.
Why haven't we thought of him? And then the other part of my brain's going, there's no need to think of Afro Man. We've had other things to do.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like I never knew him. So I haven't.
Sure.
I've never thought of him.
It's not his eulogy.
But you know what I mean? Like,
yeah, he was gone too soon. I never got a chance to know him.
Not like I haven't thought of him for a while. I've never thought of him.
Yeah.
So that's an interesting point. If someone brings up someone, we have no idea who they are.
Hold the phone, Eli. Yeah. Andy's challenging here. And,
but no, you did know. So,
I did know, yeah,
but
it is an interesting legal case to make.
Yeah. Because you knew, let's give it to Eli. What hat do you want, by the way, Eli?
Pardon?
What hat did you want, by the way, mate? Guinness?
Little Athletics Guinness.
Or the physio creme.
Oh, mate, surprise me.
Well, you want a good surprise or a bad surprise?
give me a good surprise.
I'll give you a little athletics hat then.
Okay, good.
But give it to a little champion.
Let Eli go, but hey.
No, Ando, can I say I'm disappointed you didn't challenge harder? Because you are, you know, you fight hard to make people win their hats. Yeah. We've had one 24-hour long challenge, which you lost.
I learnt my lesson.
But
you don't go back into court.
But
you know,
I think
James heard from Essendon, should have learned his lesson. Don't keep fighting.
I think you could have made a case there to go, but I never knew him.
Never knew
so
him.
So you can't name. I mean, the rules of the game are they have to be a household name. Yeah. So I think you could have had a case there.
Okay, from now on.
You could have had a case there,
Greg.
I don't know him.
Sorry, Ham. Greg, 131060 is the number. Greg, tell us something we haven't thought about for a while.
Ahoy, Hamish and Andy.
Ahoy, Grego.
Let me tell you, I've taken the afternoon off work. I've had this one lined up for a couple of weeks.
Good. I hope win, Greg, but we do have to play honestly.
No, you haven't thought it. Okay. Gabriella Chilmi.
Nah, sorry, mate.
What?
Mate,
she's friends with my cousin. Yes. She's friends with my cousin.
And one of our mates tutored her.
I haven't thought of her since 2008.
Yeah, I know, but Greg,
what we're learning here is... you know, we got different brains.
Yeah.
And different brains will think of different people.
Hey, Greg, Ed Sheeran name drops her in one of his songs as well.
He does, yeah.
I don't listen to Ed.
Ah, well, that's why you've lost a hat.
Greg, what hat would you have picked?
The Guinness.
Yeah, smart mate. All right, Greg, bad luck. Better luck next time.
Sorry you took the day off work, but you'll get us next time. Lockie.
Lachlan.
Yep.
Ahoy.
Ahoy, how are we, boys?
We're good, Lock. Ready to go.
I've got an old one from a classic ad. I've gone Sydney from Sydney's Furniture.
Again, I don't know who.
Like he's gone like, nice one, Sydney. Nice one, mate. Sydney.
Furniture is great.
It was great. Yeah, that's the one.
So Abe does know.
Look, it rings bells, but I couldn't. To me, it's a furniture store like Godfrey's vacuum cleaners. I mean, I don't know Godfrey.
But he's an Aussie. He's an Aussie icon.
Aussie.
He's like Skippy.
Well, no, because people know Skippy.
Don't remember Sydney ferreting through the bush trying to find lost children. Lucky. No, I think it's too obscure. We love you, but I mean, we're just...
No, I'm calling a hard no after the Eli incident earlier on where I should have been harder.
It's a hard no, Lock. Sorry.
Taryn on 131060. Wrap this up for us, Taryn. Tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
Ahoy, Taryn.
I'm very confident, actually, with this one. I've had this one for about 2 weeks.
Okay.
So I'm going with Shirley Temple.
Yeah. I haven't. I think it's fair to say I haven't either.
Well done.
I mean...
Thank you.
A historical figure.
She comes up, doesn't she? But...
do you know what? I
can't identify the exact case.
I'd be unfair to say I'd thought of her because I was mucking around with a friend the other night at the bar, thinking of just making a joke about bad drinks to order.
Yeah.
And Shirley Temple is, I think, kind of like a
drink.
Sugar.
Yeah.
It's like a cocktail,
but
I don't think there's any alcohol in it.
Yep.
And I was trying to remember the name of a Shirley Temple, but instead I said a Virgin Bloody Mary.
Right.
But
So you didn't? You thought about thinking about it?
I had her just outside the house. I don't think I let her in. So I'm going to give it. I'm going to give it. Double checking.
Taryn, what hat do you want?
Oh, I think I've got to go to Guinness.
You've got to go to Guinness, which means physio creme has jackpotted as the movie prize to next week.
Crap-potted all the way to next week. Same as Shandy. Excited to play this game.
It's been a while since I've thought
about... John Hewson,
former opposition leader.
It's been a while since I've seen them.
You would have failed.
Who else?
You thought about John Hewson recently?
Not really thought about him. Watched him on Q&A.
Oh, was he on Q&A, was he?
He's a bit of a regular on Q&A.
Oh, jeez. What are the chances of that? The only show you watch that's not football with a degree after it. 360, 180, yeah. 1080.
Yeah, football 1080.
Football very dizzy.
From all angles.
Yeah. Okay.
We repeat a few of the angles.
So, a disappointing start by me. I would not have won a hat there. That's why this is such a tough game. Tell us someone we haven't thought about in a while.
Yeah.
Someone we haven't thought about this year is usually how we classify it. And you can just think...
Late May, I suppose. I mean, I still think this year's good
for
the game.
It's fair. Mm. You just think you got an absolute cracker in the torpedo tube. Yeah. You fire John Hewson out of your torpedo tube. He's shooting through the water so fast. Yeah. And he just can't penetrate the hull.
No, I just dodged it.
He sailed off into the water. And so apologies to John Hewson. I haven't watched your great work on Q&A lately. Well done to Ando.
Hey, Ham.
Good block.
Obviously, people are playing for hats. So companies have been sending hats in.
It's an absolute hat-a-lanche at the moment, great. Ando. Keep them coming in, though, because you never know when your hat will make it on the show.
So what are the hats on offer today?
Has to be the cheapest advertising on radio because it costs you a hat to get on the show.
Well, it's very cheap for physio-crem.
I wouldn't say it's advertising for physio-crem, but we'll get to them in a moment.
Yeah.
PJ Pools and Spas have said it's one hat, but that's all right. Someone will love that. It's a nice standard trucker.
I might get my hands on that if it doesn't go off
today. Great. Yeah, great. Vroomvroom.com. Don't know what you do. Don't love your hat game.
No, what is it? Can you explain the hat for
What's
everyone?
At the back here, Ando? My least favourite.
Oh, right.
The fabric and buckle, not a snapback.
No.
But look, it certainly gets a message out there for the company, and I suppose...
Plain blue for people playing.
Very, very dark navy.
I wouldn't say that the logo of the company is cool, though, would you?
No. Let's go for... let's look at the brim stiffness. Super stiff brim. Probably spent a lot of their cash on reinforcing the brim.
Yep.
Don't know if this makes sense to people, but it's one of those... thicker brim, soft fabric hats.
Okay.
Not the best hat.
And then
you've got a...
In third prize?
Well, for third place. I feel like I need some tongs in here to pick this up. Who's this? Who's this poop of a hat?
Physio-creme. It's purple.
The purple physio-creme
entry level.
What is physio-creme, you ask? It's the world's number one pain-relieving cream. Can't rate it highly enough as a... cream.
As a creme?
As a creme. But when it comes to hats, they have produced what can only be described as the absolute bottom of the barrel. If the creme is on top, this is from the bottom of the barrel. This is the dregs
sediment
of the hat world. So you've got the purple physio creme hat. This is the prize that if you win today, I mean, this will be picked third, it always is.
Someone emailed in him and asked specifically for the physio creme hat for a boyfriend's.
Is it becoming too famous? And I've got something else to bring up if we've got time quickly.
Yeah.
We often wonder if the people from Physio Creme, I mean, they sent this hat in months ago.
Yeah, I'm often worried that they don't like us talking about their hat every week.
Look at this.
Have they updated their hats?
Physio Creme.
Hames opening a box. It's been express posed.
Physio creme have sent us in bedazzled physio creme hats with diamantes on them in a valiant effort to jazz up one of the world's worst hats.
They have, and they've made it worse. I don't know how they could do it.
This is for you. It's got a bedazzled A on the back.
Well, that's a prize today. I don't want that. So that goes in the prize pool.
Oh, okay. So today you're actually playing for the bejeweled Andy
version.
Limited edition physio creme hat. But remember, limited edition is not always great. Sometimes there's only one of a bad thing as well.
You get to call up now. Tell us someone we haven't thought about for a while. It can be a famous person, of course, a character.
Here's mine. Sorry, it's a black physio creme hat.
Anyway, we'll play the game after this.
I do rate it, physio creme.
Love it.
Still, very bad hats. Alan, best of luck.
Ahoy, guys.
Ahoy to you. Ahoy, Alan.
Yeah, I was actually going to ask Kim Beazley earlier, but then you had the John Hewson thing, so that's pretty lucky.
Well, you didn't go Kim Beazley, actually, because we were talking about Kim the other night.
Yep.
Greatest Prime Minister Australia ever had.
Hmm. Okay. I'm going to go with a pretty disrespectful Alan. It's Alan Bond.
Have we thought of Alan Bond?
Alan Bond.
I think I have.
Yeah.
I'm really sorry, Alan, to poo-poo a namesake, but
It was, I was talking to my dad about his failed shopping centre exploits in Queensland. And I just know we had that conversation a couple of weeks ago. I'd love to pretend I didn't have it, Alan.
Sorry, Alan. But I mean, you had me, but you just didn't get past Haim.
Dad would be shattered if I didn't remember the conversation, because Dad had a lot of facts about the business.
Chris, tell us something we haven't thought of for a while.
Ahoy, fellas.
Ahoy, you. Ahoy, Chris.
Guys, Stuart Diver.
Stuart Diver?
Yep, Stuart Diver.
Here we go. Ando's thought of him.
Yes, we're talking about Stuart Diver's the...
Threadbow disaster.
Yes, we would. You and I would have this discussion.
I know, I remember. Jog my memory?
We were talking about all those... We actually listed all the disaster famous people.
Oh, yeah, actually,
people.
Sorry, Chris, because I mentioned the Chilean miners.
Yes.
And bugger.
Yes, yeah, Hamish, a couple of weeks ago, I thought the Chilean miners was a good one.
Yeah.
Stuart Diver came up.
We went through all... In the song, we went through all the...
Subterranean heroes. So, apologies, Chris. That category was really, really covered.
Lauren, tell
ahoy,
us.
Please.
Ahoy, Lauren. Ahoy, good luck. We want you to get a hat, but we do have to be honest. Tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
Well, Miss Patty off Mr. Squiggle. The one they go, it's upside down, Miss Patty.
Very good. I didn't know that was their name, but I haven't thought of...
Maybe they've changed, but the blackboard used to always say upside down.
Yeah, he used to say upside down.
Somebody said it's upside down, Miss Patty, to Miss Patty.
Right. If her name was Miss Patty, I mean, you've got it.
I don't think I've ever heard of this character, Miss Patty.
I'm sure you have.
Okay, Lauren, we've got judges rushing around here. Lauren, you start talking to Andy about what hat you might like while I just quickly
Google.
What
hat were you going to go with? I mean,
look, I work with a bunch of physios, so my heart was on the physio cream one.
Oh, would you like the physio cream bedazzled one?
I would love a limited edition physio cream bedazzled hat.
Well, hang on just a second there, Lauren.
Come on.
Just Googling now.
Anything, Ham? Anything you got? Miss Patty, you say. Miss Patty, I think it is.
It was Miss Pat. But I'm getting
it. Yeah, but they said Patty.
Lauren,
I was want the hat off my head.
We're going to give it to you. Someone has finally cleared out the physio cream hat.
No, she's just getting the bedazzled one.
Oh, she's just getting the limited edition, which means we've got the regular garden variety one still stinking up the
well done,
prize
Lauren.
Pool.
Carl, how are you?
Ahoy, boys.
We've had a winner. Carl. I mean, I can't remember ever knowing that character to begin with, which is a technicality, but we've got it. We're giving it away. Carl, tell us something we haven't thought of for a while.
Milo and Otis.
Sorry, mate.
Oh, when did you watch Milo? Did you watch it?
You made a Milo Otis joke on this show just recently.
God, I make so many of them, though, that must just be without thinking. We do mention Milo and Otis a lot, Carl. Mm. It's a bit of a go-to reference for any kind of either scenario where animals are being trained, film without human characters.
Yep.
There's a couple of categories you can rely on Milo and Otis for. I know, Carl, because it seems like a goodie, doesn't it? What hat would you have gone, Carl?
The creme hat.
Yeah, the original, not the bedazzled one.
Jeez. Now I'm sad you didn't win, too, Carl, because we want it off our hands. Charlie, last chance here. Tell us someone we haven't thought about for a while. Ahoy, Charlie.
Ahoy, boys, ahoy. And happy birthday week, Andy.
Come on, mate. Please, can we stop
this? Hey, Charlie, you know the right buttons to push.
I'm a bit concerned because I know you touched on Olympic Australian athlete. Mm. But I'm going to go with Jumping Jai Tarima.
Sorry, mate.
No.
We did.
We mentioned him just recently because I was saying to Haim, I was actually at the London Olympics where there was a different jumper there, long jumper, Australian guy, who came second. Very good. Couldn't remember his name. We were talking about great branding Jumping Jai Tarima.
Because Jumping Jai was a high jumper, wasn't he?
No, he was a long jumper. Okay,
wasn't he?
He was a long jumper, but he used to smoke.
Challenge.
No, what do you mean challenge?
He's made he was long jump.
Are you sure?
Well, what do you want to put on it?
Oh, mate, physio creme hat. Well, either way, I remember Jumping Jai.
Because he used to smoke and jump.
Ah, who was the guy that had the long bounce with the long hair for the high jump?
Oh, yeah, not him. Forsyth.
Tim someone.
Tim Forsyth.
Okay. Challenge was retracted, but Charlie, no win for you.
Haim, time to play this.
It's been a while since I've thought
about Mary Pierce, the famous French tennis player.
Yeah, and it's been a while since I've seen them.
Cannot say I've thought about Mary Pierce.
In your life?
No, this year.
Yeah.
And under the rules of the game. God, I've thought about it a lot 5 years ago.
Yep. I mean, well, I thought about it a lot when in my late teens.
Sure. I understand what you're getting at. I think you've won a hat. Thank you. And that's the game, guys. Yeah. Tell us someone we haven't thought about for a while. And a while is this year. If you can name someone that we can't honestly tell you that we've thought about them this year, you win. But it's got to be a well-known person.
Hey, and people send in hats, business send in hats. Are we saying don't send any more hats? We've got too many? Or
we have been overloaded by hats, but I don't think it will stop the hat flood because we have so... I've just lucky dipped today.
Great.
So, obviously, we do have a ton of hats.
Sure. First time we've seen...
A bucket hat?
A bucket hat, yeah.
And it's Deliveroo. Right. Deliveroo have sent in a bucket hat. It's not bad.
It's not a bad hat. As far as...
You realise sort of, you know, it's not made at the highest quality hat factory because on the inside tag it says style number CH31.
Yep.
So who knows what they were thinking at Deliveroo headquarters when they went past CH30 and all the others. But that's that'll work.
Yep.
Ultimate Performance Supplements have sent in a very, very blue hat.
Yes.
That's a baseball cap, but it's
flexi-fit.
Bit of a flexi-fit, bit of an elastic, but it's a small medium.
That's good, though. Flexi-fit's, I'd say, premium over, say, a Velcro or a buckle.
Yeah, if it fits. I mean, that's always the gamble you've got with a flexi-fit or a new era hat. Like, it has to kind of fit your head. But if it does, if you think you're a small medium, I would certainly be recommending you get the UPS Ultimate Performance Supplements hat, especially if you're into the gym, if you like going to the gym, and you want to look like you're sponsored.
Is that
great hat? Here's one that's maybe a bit more up in terms of sponsorship up our alley, Ando.
Yeah.
Downside, it is a Velcro hat. It's the cheapest back fastener, in my opinion,
you can have on
a hat, apart from the fabric strap and buckle.
Yeah.
You see in some more older gentlemen's baseball caps, which I'm not a fan of. It's a Darryl Lee hat.
Very, very bright. What's it got?
It's attention-seeking. It's lairish.
It's one of the ugliest things I've seen.
It's got a rainbow stripe down the middle.
It's a spew of colours.
It is a lot of colours. Yep. It's certainly not the ugliest thing we've seen. I think we know who takes that cake.
Yeah, I didn't realise it was out again. Yes.
If all those hats aren't available, you will be forced to take the remaining hat, which is the purple Physio Creme hat. Physio Creme, world's number one sports creme, and world's number billion hat.
Tell us something we haven't thought of for a while.
Even if you had a Viking hat with the horns on the inside that gouged your head every time you wore it, you'd prefer that over the Physio Creme hat.
Yes.
But Ando?
Yeah.
It's there, and you'll be forced to win it if
we get down to four people.
There's nothing left.
I doubt that, though. 13-10-60, tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while. Time to play Tell Us Someone We Haven't Thought Of For A While. This is exciting.
It's a hard game. Easily the most amount of disappointed people at the People's Show calling up because everyone thinks that they've got a cracker.
Yep.
You know, you go to yourself, the Chilean miners, that's a winner. Mm. And if we've thought of it, and we can think of some weird people. Unfortunately, Ando and I have a life where our job is only 2 hours a day, and that's talking anyway.
Yep.
So, for the rest of the day, most of it is spent in mindless conversation.
Yes.
And in that conversation, a lot of people are going to come up, so you're up against it.
Noah's up against it first. Noah.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy to you, mate. Ahoy, Tell us Noah. Someone we haven't thought of for a while.
I'm thinking it's a risky one. But I'm thinking Richard Dean Anderson.
Who's Richard Dean?
He's MacGyver.
Oh.
He's MacGyver, isn't he, Noah?
Yes, he is, Hamish.
I've thought of MacGyver.
Do you know what?
Oh, no!
I think I have had this chat with a friend of mine because they wanted to go to the Australian Comic Con and he was the guy that was at the Australian Comic Con.
No, well, there you go.
A couple of years ago.
I mean, but I...
Because they were saying, who are you going to get the Australian Comic Con? I said, oh, look, don't judge too quickly because MacGyver was there a few years ago.
Yes.
Richard Dean Anderson.
If we'd said MacGyver would... This is an interesting point in the game.
Mm.
Would we have thought of Richard Dean Anderson?
I think you'd have to... I mean, you go, yo, I'm thinking of the guy's face, and that's him.
Yep.
So...
Exactly. So you're losing on two counts there. Joel's bad luck, Noah. Joel... No hat for Noah, but is there a hat that you're eyeing off? I'm not sure if you heard which ones are which.
No, I've been trying to get on the line. So
yeah, smart, mate. That's all right. We'll run you through them in a second if you are successful, but tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
All righty. Drum roll, boys. Big Kev, who used to sell the cleaning products?
Yep, you got me.
Pretty good.
Yeah, exactly.
Well done. Joel, well done. You got a hat.
Absolute wish.
Yes.
absolute swish. And Kev, we watched it sail through the air. We thought, oh my God, it's never going to touch the backboard. And it didn't. Really good shot, Joel.
So,
So Joel, do you have a medium to small head?
Oh, I've got a large head.
Yeah, Joel, that rules you out of the best hat then, I reckon.
I wouldn't recommend the Ultimate Performance Supplements hat then. It does quite clearly say small, medium.
I would recommend... Do you like a bucket hat, like a Wally type hat? Or
yeah, mate, we'll go bucket hat.
Yeah, I reckon it's better for
Joel,
him.
Joel,
yeah,
you got the delivery Joel? Bucket hat.
You've got a promotional hat from a company who just sent it in for a, for a chance to be named. Didn't have, but Joel's a victorious.
Well done. Well done, Joel. I mean, you can turn it inside out if you don't want to advertise them.
Yeah,
I'm
sure.
Just doing that. I'm doing that now. It's not as attractive.
We'll put a bit of black gaffer over it.
Choices to be made for you, Joel, when you get the hat, and well done.
Alina, is that how I say it? Alina?
Yes, yes it is.
Alina, ahoy, welcome to the show.
Ahoy.
Tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while, Alina.
Good luck.
Selwyn.
Oh, yeah.
No, we have.
Have we had him on this before?
What do you mean?
Because he came out for Rumba, didn't he?
Yes,
we were talking about Rumba just
Rumba, Alina. So, Alina, I'll tell you a music festival you haven't thought of in a while. Rumba.
the station here back in the day tried to hold their own music festival. It's called Rumba. Selwyn's still got, I think,
posted around here somewhere.
But Alina. Unlucky, yes.
God, we basically got a Selwyn room here at the station. Sorry, Alina.
Always risky going pop stars.
Because, but I think, you know, a Selwyn's a great, he's a punchline. He's like an Urkel or a Corey the Party Boy.
He sang the reboot. Didn't he sing the reboot of You're a Rich Girl? So was that true?
I'm going to call it right now. Too much time spent on Selwyn.
Okay, sure.
Jaden, ahoy. Welcome to the show.
Ahoy, boys.
Jaden, you've seen how hard it is.
Good luck.
Meryl Bainbridge.
Oh, pretty good. She sung one of those. Oh, no. Did she sing that song where they're just in the back of a car making out for the film clip?
Oh, I don't know the film clip. That was a long time ago.
Because I saw this the other day. I saw this and I was like, what is this
Am
film
I thinking
clip?
Shania Twain? This is a hard
Crazy
one.
Just for you. Da, 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 da. When I kiss your mouth.
Did she think
Yeah, that's it.
That's yeah, her. No, I thought of it.
Sorry, mate. I watched the film clip. I know. It's a really awkward film clip because it's just black and white in the back
when
of it.
Did you watch the film clip?
It was just on Foxtel.
All right.
And I was like, what is this? What is this film clip?
Yeah.
And then we just watched it the whole way through and I was like, you just had extreme tongue fatigue because it's just her making out for the whole song. Kind of sexy at first, and then it
Jaden took it poorly, Jaden. But that's fine. Paul,
I love it. I love the passion.
Paul, tell us something we haven't thought of for a while. Only one person's been successful today. That's normally the average, I would say.
Good luck, Paul.
Ahoy, boys.
And ahoy. Ahoy and good luck, sir.
I'm sure this guy hasn't done the rumba with you guys. Mikhail Gorbachev.
I haven't thought.
I'm so sorry. I just read a book. People might be aware by a guy called Cal Fussman who does interview celebrities, and Gorbachev was his big interview. So he talks about
he made a fuss about it.
He made a fuss, man. He does in Esquire magazine they do a thing called What I've Learned at the back, and he interviews a celebrity, and like Gorbachev was his big get. So.
Sorry,
I reckon a few weeks ago there was a day where I thought about Mikhail Gorbachev for about 4 hours. And so that is an absolute, if we're doing basketball analogies, Paul, you've gone up for a dunk and I've just hit the ball up into the bleachers.
Yeah.
You look like a goose, but now the cheerleaders are looking at me. Gorbachev's helped me out. Sorry, Paul.
Hamish Andy. Time for...
It's been a while since I've thought
about the violinist's bond. Remember the violin group, those girls?
It's been a while since I've seen them.
Remember that?
Yeah, I remember them.
Who else?
And that just hot girl violin quartet?
Yeah.
Oh, they're always just like going crazy violining in the ocean and stuff and falling over and just being
babes. It was very
babes.
Important that the violining was ferocious.
To see a slight amount of jiggle. What? I think that's what you're saying.
That's not.
You sicko. I just liked the album. I wasn't interested in the film clip.
That's not what I was saying.
You big old perv. but it was very crazy violining, wasn't it? And they would just be running around violining. And we never got a follow-up album.
They're on, the rocks as the surf came in and crashed against it. And, probably silly places to record violining, you would think.
I think it was dubbed. I think they probably went and did a master track. But would I have won a hat in we haven't thought about
absolutely.
That person for a while?
That's the way this game works. Tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while. If we haven't thought of them this year, you win a hat. Hats
like
have been sent in.
Violin Quartet Bond.
Yep.
Ando,
Here are today's hats that you can win if you can name someone we haven't thought about this year. We, of course, have to prove that we have thought about them.
Two new ones and an old favourite?
Yep. You know who's at the back. We'll just go through three because we only ever really give away one hat. Yeah. First hat off the rank.
Yep.
I got to say,
I like the look of it.
I like a lot of stuff about this hat.
Yep.
It's a high-quality trucker.
Yep.
It's red. It's a bold red, a cherry red,
yep.
Which can be a lot of fun. A bit What's harder if you're a pale complexion person to pull off a bright red hat, but it might be your thing. Your standard CH69 trucker hat. I see this pop up a lot. That's the model number from the Chinese factory. Here's the hard bit. Normally, it's a company's promotional hat. There's just a small golf ball, an animated sort of character on the front.
So that might be some company's logo, but we don't know the company, so...
All I can say is it's really promoting golf in a fun way.
Yeah, okay.
In a fun way, so you'll be happy with that. And he's holding what appears to be a putter, so maybe it's a mini golf course.
And he's wearing a red hat.
He's wearing the same red hat. And then on his hat is the same thing,
wow.
And so on and so forth, to right down to the molecular level. So yes. Really, it's, you know, it could be a billion hats in one.
Mm-hmm.
Love that hat, although it's for a child's head. Warning, child's hat, or if you're a pinhead.
Okay.
Second hat, this, I believe, it just says give some good on the front. That's so a nice like embroidery. You look at charity. We see a lot of embroidery that really messes with the shape of the hat because people tend to go for cheap hats when they're free hats.
Yep.
At the back, it's vinniesgoodshop.org.au. It's St. Vincent's.
Yeah, great.
Unless it's someone.
Velcro at the back.
Not my favorite.
Not our favorite. But I mean,
infinitely adjustable. Yep. A lot of people like that.
And the final one?
What's this?
I could smell that from a mile away.
You stinker.
Yeah, I smell what you've stepped
the
in
purple,
over there.
The purple, the bright, a grimace purple.
Yep.
So the last colour you're putting on your head, grimace purple physio creme hat.
Yep.
What is physio creme, you might ask? It's the world's number one pain-relieving creme that's used by
physios
and osteos.
Yep.
It's trademarked.
Yep.
No need.
And number one for hats not wanted by anyone.
And the least wanted hat on the planet Earth. It's been the booby prize now since we started this game. And I'm sure it'll remain firmly in the I hate this hat bucket, which we have in the studio.
Unorthodox from us. We're going to go to an air break here.
If you think you've got too many friends and you'd love to lose them in an instant, the physio creme hat's for you. cannot rate the creme highly enough, though.
Yeah, your chance to win a hat. Just call up now. Tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
Jenny, ahoy. Welcome to the show.
Ahoy.
Ahoy to you, Jenny.
Confident with your person, Jen?
Fairly confident.
Okay, go for it.
Scott Kane from Popstars.
Sorry.
Have you thought of him?
Yeah, yeah. Remember we talked about him? Yeah, we talked about him because Hamish and I met him.
Did we?
Yes.
Yes, of course we did. That was a good day.
No, you and I had a few drinks and went to do karaoke, and he ran the karaoke.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Remember when
we were like, this is too obvious for what you should be doing, Scott.
And he used to get up and sing between everybody, and we realised he's just aspiring to be a pop star of his own. But this is before pop stars.
I recounted
that story just recently.
Sorry,
Jenny.
Sorry, Jen.
Yep.
I know it can be harsh because you do think you have a cracker in the tube, but they can't all be Bond, the all-girl violin quartet. Nathan, ahoy. Welcome to the show, Nathan.
Ahoy, fellas.
Ahoy.
Nathan, have you heard the segment before?
Yes, I have.
And have you had this person ready to go?
Oh, for a couple of weeks now because I listened to your podcast.
Okay, Nathan, this is your chance. Good luck.
Eric Clapton.
It's clear for me, I think.
Can't say I have thought of him. I mean, I'm going to give it an all clear.
Well done.
That's awesome.
I mean,
yes.
Because I think the pause was us going.
Of course you should have.
It's Eric Clapton. Yeah. I mean, the guy can play. Yep. We're obviously known for being heavily into music. Mm. We should have thought of him.
Nathan, you've got
your pick. You've got the you've got the golf ball trucker hat with the funny little golf ball character on the front. Could be suitable for a child, or if you're a pinhead, it would suit you.
Yep.
You got the
St. Vinny's
hat. That's right in the middle, blue hat with give some good on the front. That's just, you know, perfect kind of straight bat selection.
And then the worst hat of them all.
You got the physio creme hat. No one's ever selected it. It's the grimace purple,
disgusting Velcro bat.
Absolute sort of
worst thing you can have.
Person repeller for your head.
I'll go the St. Vinny's one.
Ah, good.
Good, Nathan.
It's coming your way. Nathan. Great win.
Great as if. I mean, for a second there, I thought he was going to try and be funny and take the physio cram, but you wouldn't risk it. Well, you wouldn't risk owning it because, again, it just completely damaged your career as far as fashion goes.
But you've worked so hard to win that hat. You're not at the end of a game show going to go, as a joke, I'll take an old donkey instead of a brand new Land Cruiser. Like, you're just not.
Simon, tell us something we haven't thought of for a while.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy to you, mate.
Ahoy, Simon.
Nigel Rock from Backyard Blitz.
Oh, no.
Oh, no, you can't.
Yes.
So we had Susie Wilkes. Is it because we had Susie Wilkes the other week?
It's because you and I were talking about the Celebrity Grand Prix.
Oh, and he was
remember
in that.
The other day?
Oh, no way.
I forgot
he was in it.
Yeah, you mentioned it the other day, Kelly, on the air. We talked about Kelly Slater being in the Celebrity Grand Prix.
Here's the thing. I remember Nigel. I didn't know he was on Backyard Blitz. Is that what he was a celebrity from?
And Nigel Ruck was one of the guys that was...
English guy?
Yes.
Yeah, he was a landscaper.
We were talking about him.
It's a great one, but I'm really sorry. Good. You brought up the Celebrity Grand Prix the other day, and I was thinking of who else were in there with it.
Mm. Yeah. No, well done, Simon. That's a great kick. And you just hit the woodwork.
Joel. Tell us something we haven't thought of for a while.
Very good, Joel.
Martin Sachs.
I don't mind Marty Sachs from Water Rats, probably, or at least one of those shows.
Blue Heelers, I think.
Probably Blue Heelers. He was
Blue Heelers.
He was in a lot of stuff.
All clear from me.
And it's all clear from me, Joel. That is a good tell us something we haven't thought of for a while.
Yes.
Lovely guy.
Why is it here? I won a hat last week. It still hasn't arrived to my house yet.
Okay, Joe, we're not taking complaints, mate. We're just playing the game.
Stick to this week's game. I mean, there's a huge process of clearing the hat through quarantine, getting management to sign off.
Twice.
Who did you win with last week, Joel?
I won with Big Kev last week.
Yeah, that's right. We loved him.
Mate, you're probably Australia's best player at this game, Joel. Do you know that?
Joel, what are you going to go for? You're going to go for the red hat with the golf ball on it or the stinky, stinky hat from Physio Crem?
Mate, you can keep that stinky out. I'm going golf.
Good on you, Joel. See you next week.
Literally for a hat trick.
We're out in the South Pacific, Ham, aboard. Aboard the cruise liner, the Carnival's... What is the Carnival Spirit?
Carnival Spirit and Nando's the name of our ship. Cheers, it's Wednesday. And that's the thing. We've hit a bit of a lull today.
Yep.
First couple of days at sea, everyone's been going very hard, very early.
Yep.
And that was encouraged by us. That was expected by us. Mm. We were absolutely in that boat.
Yep.
But today, everyone's just taking stock. I think we all know that the week is still young, really, and we've got 2 kilometres of sea underneath
us. I haven't seen anyone today. You and I are up early, but we haven't seen anyone.
Few people have been laid low. We've got some choppy oceans outside. Yep. Look, we're all... There's absolutely... Just having a quick squeeze out the window. Look, no pirates or anything around, but seasickness has been an enemy of a few people today. And, I mean, you and I, we're getting into a rhythm. We like to hit Bonsai, the Japanese restaurant, for lunch.
We didn't make the ice carving.
We gave the ice carving a little bit of a miss. We made it to bingo.
Yeah.
We do keep getting sucked in by this thing called Cash Crane, which is essentially a skill tester that has shrink-wrapped blocks of $500 notes in it. I mean, that's our routine. Mm. $5 notes, $105 notes.
Yeah.
And it's very, very difficult to pick up with, obviously, a very flimsy claw.
Let's get to that tomorrow, Ham, because one thing we did do today is we went to Fashion Boulevard on the boat.
Oh, what a strip.
It's 6 stores.
Rodeo Drive.
Yes.
And your big shopping strips all around Australia.
Yeah.
You know, you got your Pitt Street malls. You got Chapel Street in Melbourne.
Yeah.
And you got Fashion Boulevard here on the boat.
Yep.
It stretches out for what must be 12 metres
of
pure non-stop
shop.
One shop on the left, one shop on the right. We went to the shop on the right today.
Yes.
Because we wanted to pick up hats.
Mm.
We wanted to pick up hats because we wanted to give them to people as the prize because we are about to play, even though we're at sea.
Yeah.
Let's see if we can crank up the phone system, get the satellites working from the mainland to the ship here in the middle of the ocean. Can we play... Tell us someone we haven't thought about in a while.
131060 is the number. The way this game works, you call up and just tell us someone that we haven't thought about for a while. We're saying a while is, have we haven't thought about them this year? We've got to justify the fact that we have thought about them, tell you, recount the moment we did come up with them or had them in conversation. Hey, people always play for hats. Normally the hats have been sent in, but of course we are out at sea, so we went and bought the hats today. Run everyone through the hats.
And up first, we've got a visor. One of our first ever visors.
Yes.
We have had visors before, but none of this level of quality. Yep. This is your standard performance extreme fit visor.
Mm-hmm.
Very good for sport. Dress it up, dress it down. You could wear this for a brunch. You could wear it all the way up to an early dinner or drinks with the gals. It's got the carnival logo on the front.
Yep.
It is, of course, a carnival hat.
It would fit a men's head or a woman's head, you'd say.
It's got an adjustable Velcro strap at the end, and it looks like some sort of loop to be able to pop it on a keychain.
Mm.
Coming up next, we've got the Iguana Tequila Bar hat.
Yep.
This is a fabric hat. My least favourite fastener on the back.
Yes, a buckle fastener.
A fabric buckle fastener, but gentlemen over the age of 40 do enjoy them.
Yep.
It's the Blue Iguana
player.
Tequila Bar. Of course, on the side there. Who's this? The old Carnival logo.
Definitely getting their branding Carnival in there.
And Ando.
Yes.
Can I throw one more hat in?
Of course.
Of course, this segment is to promote businesses.
Yep.
Usually, we just get companies sending us in their hats. There's someone I think needs a bit of promotion.
Hmm.
I'll put my Best Fun Steve hat.
Best Fun Steve. Wow.
There's only two of these hats.
I wasn't going to suggest it if you felt the pressure.
There's only two of these hats in existence. One sits on Best Fun Steve's hat.
He's a listener that's come. He won his way in. He's about 55, and he is, in fact, the Best Fun so far on this trip.
Andy tried to keep him off the boat. I voted to save him.
Yep.
As a sign of solidarity with Steve, I got two of these hats made. I've been wearing one myself,
yep.
And Best Fun Steve's been wearing his one now. You have refused to apologise to Steve as yet because you're hoping that he might burn out by the end of the week.
He's been very good so far. And everyone's around him. They love him. And
I had someone come up to me today and go, you know what we're doing today? And I said, what are you doing? What activity are you doing? And they said, mate, we're just doing nothing. And I said, that's pretty good. And go, you know who inspired us to do it? I said, who? And I went, Best Fun Steve. And I said, you know what Best Fun Steve does when he wakes up?
What?
He said, he tears up a schedule. He hates schedules. I mean, how good is he? How good's Best Fun Steve?
Anyway, they're the three hats.
You can win a Best Fun Steve hat.
131060 is the number. Hamish, we're going to try and hopefully, if the satellites permit, cross back for one of our favourite segments, Ham. It's got an opener.
It does, Ando.
Let's fire it off.
It's been a while since I've thought about Brooke Shields.
Yeah.
And it's been a while since I've seen them. Who else?
Would I have won him?
Quick question.
Would I have won with
Brooke Shields married to Andre Agassi?
Yes.
I was looking at the cover of his tell-all book,
yeah,
and I was like, I wonder if he talks about his wife, who I didn't think about Brooke Shields by name, but I remember her being the famous wife of Andre Agassi.
Oh, gosh.
I'm going to have to say no hat.
would have been... I mean, I hope there's something not as contentious as that, but that's the way the game works. Have we thought about someone this year?
You think about a lot of people.
Yes.
That's how it happens.
And we're going to go back to dry land now where Leanne waits. Leanne, ahoy.
Ahoy there, boys.
Leanne, sorry, there's obviously a bit of a delay because we're hundreds of nautical miles out to sea, but Leanne, tell us someone we haven't thought about in a while.
Over.
Tamsin Sursok.
I have thought about Tamsin Sursok. She actually went to do Days of Our Lives.
Yep.
I think over in the States. And
I know you've... And has followed her quite closely in his locker at the radio station. He's still got a few posters up.
No, Ham, because the reason why I did think of her is because you and I went to the set...
Yes, many years ago.
At CBS, and I drove past that recently in April, and I went, it reminded me of the time we went to the Days of Our Lives set where Tamsin Sursok was.
Jeez, that's unlucky, but that's how it works. That's how it works.
Caitlin, tell us something we haven't thought about for a while. Over.
Oh, ahoy. I wanted to know if you were thinking about Wes Carr.
Have we thought about Wes Carr for a while?
He was an Australian Idol singer.
He was
the rocker.
Woolly head, kind of looked at a little bit, sort of, you know, had a beard and kind of like fluffy hair, like a lion.
Yeah, I haven't thought about it.
I don't think I've thought about Wes Carr.
Yes! Well done. Now, what hat would you like, Caitlin? You've got the choice of the Best Fun Steve hat, as previously worn.
A pre-loved by me.
Relentlessly by Hamish over the last 3 days. The Blue Iguana Tequila Rum Bar hat. It's blue. It's got probably an elderly statements type buckle at the back.
Yeah, it's an old man buckle, but some people like those. Or you've got the performance extreme fit Carnival Cruise Lines visor. What do you feel like, Caitlin?
I think I'm going to go Best Fun Steve.
You'd be mad. Well, you'd be mad well not to.
And that
is coming to you. I'll wear it. I'll keep it nice and safe for you for the rest of the trip. And as soon as we get to Vanuatu, I'll post it back. You should have it in 9 weeks.
Caitlin, well done. Hamish, I sense a slight bit of disappointment that you're losing your best friend.
It's gone to a better place. And the whole point of getting the hat on the show is to promote your business. And my business is Best Fun Stephen. I want everyone to know what a great fun guy he is.
Jemima now joins us. Tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while. Ahoy, Jemima, over.
Ahoy, boys. I don't think you've thought of Casey Chambers in a while.
Casey Chambers? No, we think of Casey Chambers.
Yeah. Didn't she do something with Troy Cassidaley recently? Are they married?
Just searching around the room, a lot of head shaking.
I saw them do a concert together.
Yeah, there was some kind of concert recently. But yeah, sorry, unfortunately.
I just feel like I know we owe you a larger burden of proof than that, but yeah. I just got to tell you that I have.
Yeah.
I think about her a lot. I think she's a great artist. Want to hear more of her stuff?
Yeah.
Might go back to my cabin after this and see if I can grab some of her gear on Spotify.
Shannon, wrap this up for us. Tell us someone we haven't thought about for a while.
Ahoy, boys. Ahoy.
Ahoy. Mike Whitney. Now we've thought about him.
I think we've had him in this segment. I think he's one of those guys that, sorry, mate, yeah, he's just below a Steve Urkel or a Nicky Webster, but he's one of those people fits into the category of isn't this guy funny?
And we talked about him more recently, Ham, because you and I were talking about Gladiators.
Yes, which we actually, I mean, there's no way you could have known this, Shan, but we talked about the first incarnation of Gladiators quite a lot, almost on a weekly basis.
Yes.
So if for future games, if you think you're doing anyone from that Vulcan Hammer, any of those guys, danger. We do think about those guys a lot, specifically their overlord and grandmaster, Mike Whitney. It was like their trainer, if you want to use a Pokemon reference.
I think he was the ref.
Yeah, no, he owned them, and he'd like release them from the cage to battle everyone, and he'd round them up at the end of the day.
Like Oliver Reed in Gladiators, I think.
Exactly. So again, Shannon, really bad luck. Our hat went off. The Best Fun Steve hat has gone off. And speaking of homemade clothing, Ando, got an update again from last night's shenanigans as we tried to sell black market T-shirts.
You left me in the lurch. And
I did not, but it will be for everybody to judge. Strenuously defend my position.
The people's cruise, everyone.
Ham, time to play.
It's been a while since I've thought
about Doug Mulray.
Oh, yeah.
And it's been a while since I've seen them. Who else?
Doug Mulray.
That's good. You would want to have had Ando. Blast from the past.
Blast from the past, a famous talk show back in the day. Doug Mulray show.
You would have wanted to have. And that's how easy it is to play. And already I can just see the switchboard has exploded.
Yes.
Because if you can tell us someone we haven't thought about this year, we classify that as haven't thought about them in the role in a while. And the reason we're giggling is because Andy has just seen what can only be described as a turn of a hat.
You get a chance to win a hat.
You do get a chance to win a hat.
Companies are sending in their hats.
And they are sending them in like hotcakes. Don't let them dissuade you, though, if you are a company, big or small, send your hats in. Now, you've seen Ando the hat. I usually pick three. We've never given away more than two in the segment. I usually pick three out of the box that have been sent in, and I always finish with letting people know that the purple physio creme hat has remained ungiven away, and so it should. I always accidentally put it in the bin
on the way out.
That it's garbage. It would be right at home in Oscar the Grouch's trash can.
Yeah,
but it is a very, very standard, bland
purple,
jarringly purple hat.
Yeah,
got a very
basic.
Really basic logo on the front. It looks like it's Arial font, Arial italicized, physio creme.
Yep.
We have both individually used the product. Wonderful creme. Wonderful.
They put all the technology and research into the creme.
Creme de la creme of physio cremes. Yeah. But and look at that fastener at the back. Terrible Velcro. You can tell that you can hear how cheap it is at the back. Just a real stinker of a hat.
Okay, have the other ones. We've covered off.
You're gonna laugh when the reason I started with physio creme today is because look who else. Look, you sent in the next hat, Ando. Yeah. I guess they're talking about pain-relieving creams a lot.
Tiger Bar!
Tiger Balm wants in on it.
I quite like the hat.
Good hat, Tiger Balm. Physio Krem's going to be hating this.
Tiger Balm.
Really nice hat.
Orange. It's got a great. It's got the logo of the Tiger Balm.
A leaping tiger. It's an eye-catching light orange.
Yes.
the peak is a better quality than Physio Krem.
And the clasp at the back?
Not my favourite clasp.
Not your favourite clasp.
But it has the decal, the Tiger Balm decal on the silver buckle. It's one of the buckle clasps.
But it looks like a snap buckle rather than a thread-through buckle.
You're right. So well done, Tiger Balm. I'm obviously just hearing weeks and weeks of Physio Krem dominating this segment and going, hang on a second. If all it takes is a hat, get us in.
And a good one. But the problem is they've sent in a good hat, which means it should be gone.
Actually, for promotional purposes, you want to send in a bad
what
hat.
What have we got last
and
one?
A real... real middle of the road hat here. Yeah. Too promotional for my liking.
Yeah, way too.
But it's a nice, I'm not aware of the company. It's called Motorhome Conversion Company, which I hope means they just take a house and put wheels on it. I didn't know it was a business.
Yeah. An attempt at something fashionable at the front with the kind of a yellow.
No, that to me says auto parts store. Yeah. So it's a black,
peaked
hat, and then it has an attempt to change the color of the peak into a yellow on the side,
yellow stripe.
I think it's super. It really looks like a ultra chin. I think is what I'm thinking.
Yeah, I mean probably the kind of hat you might see a kind of a Talladega Nights type driver, a NASCAR type driver we're using.
I'm sure the people that work for the company wear it. I wouldn't say it gets a lot of wear outside of employees, but that's your chance to change it today.
Simon, tell us something we haven't thought of for a while. 131060 is the number here.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Simon.
Simon, who you got?
Carson from Queer Eye for the Straight Guy.
We actually had a mate send us a joke picture last night.
A mate texted us yesterday.
There's a shot from the Cavs winning. The
Cleveland Cavaliers winning the NBA final, and the owner looks a lot like Carson Kressley.
I think our mate has actually been sending that joke to a lot of people, and Andy and I, because didn't you feel like it felt rehearsed?
Yeah.
So he's just sent around saying,
that happened yesterday.
I know. What a
bad luck, Simon. That's all right. Next time. Emma, tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Em.
I say Belvedere from Good Morning Australia, Bert's sidekick.
Sorry.
I think we've had him in the segment.
Yeah.
Really?
Belvedere actually is a floor manager. Yeah. And Hamish and I see him he works on a lot of other shows, Belvedere.
Yeah.
And so Hamish and I see him rather regularly. I can't remember the last time we saw him, but was definitely working on a TV project this year.
Oh, well, Em.
Bella.
You do what you can.
We don't call him Belvedere, though, to his face, because that's not his name.
Ahoy, Amy. How are you?
Ahoy. I'm good. How are you?
Yeah, we're good, Amy. Who haven't we thought of in a while?
I've got a really good one. Mm-hmm. Last Ketchup, the band that sang the Ketchup song.
I'm lost on that,
which means it's a fail, because I don't even know the song.
What's the Ketchup song, Amy?
It was like some weird language. This one, hello.
Jack, that was very quick for you. No, we have to cover for about half a minute for Jack to find something.
No.
This is a rare loss.
It's a technicality. Not someone we thought of for a while.
We could never have thought of them.
We've never thought of them. Never.
Coming up donuts on the ketchup song, Amy. Yeah. Bad luck. Ahoy, Ryan. Last crack here. Rye.
Ahoy, Jen.
Who haven't we thought of for a while?
My guess is Peter Van Den Hoogen Band.
Really good, Ryan.
And Ryan, what hat do you want? Because I think you should. There's one I think you should definitely go. I'm not going to lead the witness.
So, Ryan, in case you missed the hat selections, you got the Motorhome Conversion hat. Not a bad hat, but certainly highly promotional. Not sure what they do as a company. They might put wheels on houses. They might take wheels off motorhomes. You got Tiger Balm, nice pastel orange with the leaping tiger. Mm. Also, in the pain-relieving gel or creme category.
Physio creme.
The absolute scum of hats. Physio creme.
Hard choice.
Purple physio creme hat.
I think I might have to go to Tiger Balm.
Yes! And the reason why I wanted that is because Peter Van Den Hoogen Band was
a Dutch
swimmer that used to take on Ian Thorpe, and this is a perfectly orange hat for the Dutch swimmer that you won.
Hey, Ryan, permission for Andy and I to sign the brim with a fake Peter Van Den Hoogen Band signature?
Oh, go for it.
Thank you.
He's doing it now. Stick it. Thank you, Ryan.
I was going to say, keep swimming, Ryan.
No worries.
P. Van Der Hoogenberg.
Thank you, Ryan. Hamish and Andy.
Okay, it's time for this segment, Anna. But before we play the opener and I have my guest for today, I am aware that today's is controversial.
Okay.
But let me argue it afterwards.
Okay.
It's been a while since I've thought
about Walt Disney.
Now,
now. Just be careful that you're not thinking about Disney, which we all think about. But have you thought about Walt, the old man himself?
Yeah, exactly. Any person that's being cryogenically froze.
When did you mention it?
Well, I don't know when I mentioned it.
That's what I mean. You think about Walt Disney, but you're not actually thinking about Walt Disney.
Someone recently was talking about
me. They have brown hair. Someone non-specific.
Don't try and...
Just saying, you think...
It's a bad one. You didn't have a good one.
Okay, you know who else I would have was thinking of going? Sandy Tom, the singer.
Yeah, well, much better.
But I thought we might have had her already because someone tweeted us today and said it's exactly 10 years since that song, I Wish I Was a Punk Rocker with Flowers in My Head, came out. And Jack, you'd know that because you like punk rock. And it was... But I thought I'd just get shot down for that. So I thought instead I would take us down the very exciting and interesting path of the fact that you think about Walt Disney. And you don't actually think about the old man.
And you do a fair bit.
Think about the Disney Corporation, but not the old man behind it.
Hey, what hats are available? Send in hats
to us.
Chance for the win.
We should point out that this is tell us someone we haven't thought about in a while.
People can call up on 131060. If you name someone we haven't thought about for a while, Hamish would have... absolutely lost with Walt Disney. But
I would have given it to you. If you'd have called up, I would have said, that's actually a really good point, friend.
Seems like an unbiased opinion that you just throw here. Anyway, the hats.
Ando, first hat off the rank. Yeah. And, we've got tons. But send them in. You never know. One might make it to air, but now we're really over. We're flooded with hats at the moment. Hats. But, you mean, we recycle them every week. What do we got here? A standard blue, looks like a trucker, but oh no, there's another fabric piece at the back.
Ooh.
Now I guess this is what hat companies are doing these days in an effort.
It's a hybrid.
To reinvent the hat.
I like it.
Apollo Patios.
If no one wins that today, I might take that one.
Be careful, because it's not great. it looks like quite a shallow fish.
Yeah, we don't like those.
And again, it's got the fabric adjuster at the back, which... Yes. You see more and more in the promotional hat world, and I just wonder what's wrong with the snapback. Are they too expensive?
Yep.
Do people think that this method with the fabric and the buckle fits more heads or is more comfortable? Because I don't.
I think it just looks a little bit more.
You think it looks neater?
But it does, because the fabric and the buckle looks a bit more expensive.
A head belt. No one's being fooled by your head belt. Anyway, Apollo Patios, cheers for the hat. What have we here? This is a plain fabric navy promotional hat with a white, see a bit of white piping on
the brim.
The brim, which I'm led to believe that when you're ordering your promotional hat, costs extra.
Well done.
So they've gone for a thicker gauge brim. And it's just a wave logo.
What's the class? What's the class mechanism?
This will give it away because it's got the brand at the back. Yeah. Ranwick City Council.
Oh.
So
again with the buckle and the belt.
Again with a head belt. Anyway, very, very normal blue.
Yep.
Two blue hats, I understand, with white logos, but it depends if you want to support Apollo Patios.
Yep.
Or you like the idea of having a Randwick City Council hat, which does have the advantage if you live in Randwick City, you can probably pretend you're a council worker.
That's true.
Definitely encourage people into there.
And then, of course...
What have we here? The wearable turd.
Physio creme purple, run of the mill, it's cheapest hat line.
Have you noticed any piping? No piping.
If you're talking in terms of our band, this is the Jack Post of the band.
Yeah.
The worst of the three hats.
We'll offer sun protection, but certainly won't make you look cool if you're wearing it on your head.
Oh,
and that's Jack.
Sun protection, but protection from taunts, teasers, and potentially getting beaten up.
The irony is you'd have to have such a thick skin to wear this hat, you don't actually need sun protection.
13 10 60 is the number.
Grimace Purple Physio Creme, of course, the world's leading pain relief creme, but the world's trailing hat company. No one's ever taken the Physio Creme hat. Will it go off today?
Ramsey joins us. You have to tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while. We need to state when we thought of them. We haven't thought of them, and the game's getting a little bit harder because we're still making the point. Have we thought of them this year? And as the year goes on,
it does get harder and harder. Yeah. Ramsey, ahoy. How are you?
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, mate.
Confident with
your pick? I don't think he's... Yes, I am. Miriam from There's Something About Miriam.
Very good. Took me a second. Very good. Remember There's Something About Miriam was the reality show where it was a transgender girl.
Yep.
And it was like a dating show, and then at the end they revealed...
Ramsey!
He knew it
very
too.
Good.
He knew it.
Very good.
Because I had to.
I thought
to really
he mucked
stand.
Up the name of a popular movie.
No. I mean, yes. Ramsey, it's a real Walt Disney of a guess. I mean, you think of them all the time, but you actually don't.
Ramsey, what hat do you like?
My friend can put your snout in the hat trough.
The most expensive one seems like the hybrid trucker. / felt cap with the extra piping on the brim.
That's the Apollo Patios cap. Or you've got the Randwick City Council, or, heaven forbid, Physio Creme.
I'll go the first one, the trucker one.
Yeah, nice idea, pretty mate. Good. You'll be surprised when it comes out. I think
you'll be surprised. It's a very modern trucker. It's more of a Jetsons trucker, but you're going to enjoy that hat,
Ramsey. It's a new take on it. Thank you. Thank you, Ramsey. Lynn.
Hello.
Ahoy, Lynn.
Now, Lynn, tell us someone we haven't thought of in a while.
The group Ween.
I've had Ween many times. Yeah.
Yeah, you've thought of Ween many times.
I've got them on my iPhone.
Have you really?
Yeah. Ween, I'm sorry. Yeah. What's the song they sing? Quickly, Anna, to prove it.
They've got Push the Little Daisies.
Push the Little Daisies, yep.
Classic. Why have you got that on your iPhone?
They've also got another one, which I always play you, which is that really central sax song.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, Andy, he's thought of it. He's thought of them, Lynn. I can guarantee it. Yeah.
And I was going to go for the Physio Creme hat too.
Oh, well, I mean,
now
we're disappointed.
Now we're disappointed, Lynn, because it would have been great to open the window and let that waft out.
Alistair.
Hello, boys.
Ahoy, hey, Alistair. Tell us someone we haven't thought of in a while.
I don't think I'm going to beat the first one, but I'm going to go with Priscilla Presley.
She's so unlucky.
Yeah, I saw a doco on her.
All right.
Yeah. I think when it was Elvis.
Naked Gun.
Oh, she in that?
She's in that.
She is in that.
Yeah, I watched The Naked Gun just recently.
Pretty hard, hard to watch a movie without thinking of someone in it.
Yeah.
Requires it phenomenal strength. Yes. Alistair, we do encourage you to play again. That was an honourable guess.
It was a good guess, yeah.
He was a good player. You just got unlucky on debut.
I think it was on Go just recently, The Naked Gun.
Hey, yep. You don't have to prove it to me. Jason.
Sometimes you make me.
Ahoy. Ahoy, Jace.
Ahoy, gentlemen. How are you?
We are very good. Now, tell us someone that we haven't thought of in a while.
Jackie McDonald from Hey Hey It's Saturday.
That's good for me.
I got to be honest and say, just double checking, I'm not confusing, now recognizing that with having thought of her. Yeah. It's good from me.
It's good. He's got it!
Jace.
This is so rare. There's two.
Haven't thought of her in a while.
Yes. Jackie McDonald. Not to be confused with Denise Drysdale, similar kind of ilk.
Never would. Similar haircut, I think, at some stages.
Similar haircut.
Jace, your big moment. Do you want the Randwick City Council hat?
As we said, it's a great opportunity to head around Randwick and pretend you work there.
Valid point. However, I do live a fair way away from Randwick.
Yep, sure.
And despise politicians in general.
Okay, okay.
Look, I'm going to relieve you guys of the Physio Creme hat.
Oh, it's happened. It's happened. We've actually had a thing made up in case this ever happened. We never thought we'd have to play this, but take it away.
Hello, Crap Hat, my old friend. We say farewell to Physio Creme, the world's number one sporting cream. But the worst baseball cap ever seen. Like a fabric turd that sits atop your brain. It's visual pain. To you we say good riddance.
It's out of our hands.
And Jason,
that was touching, gentlemen.
Jason, there is no calling off period.
I just want you to know, Jason, too, that applause was for you. We weren't playing ourselves applause for having made up a song.
I graciously accept the applause in hand.
Well done,
Jace. This is huge, Jace. You're absolutely going to hate it. We can't wait to send it to you.
I'll send you guys a pic with my head in it.
Jason, we're at your own risk.
I want you to do a world tour, like when people take a gnome overseas and take photos of
just getting booed throughout the world.
Just being shunned. You standing by yourself in crowded places with no one talking to you.
Not allowed on planes just because it might incite a riot. Good luck,
well
Jason.
Done, Jason.
Good luck. You're a brave fellow.
It's time for...
It's been a while since I've thought
about Baby Spice.
Yeah. And it's been a while since I've seen them.
Baby Spice or Mel G from the Spice Girls? Mel C from the Spice Girls.
There was a Mel G.
Yes. Originally there was, the sixth Spice Girl. She was kicked out because they went, look, we're chockers with Mel's. Even though Karate Spice, we would love to have you, but look, we just got so many Mel's. If you come back as a Christina or something, we'll have a think about it. And she never did. She moved on.
She really liked her name.
Baby Spice, pretty good. Pretty good for the submission of this week's round of Tell Us Someone We Haven't Thought About in a While. This is the game we play where you've got to ring up and mention someone that's obviously well known, but if we are really being honest, we haven't thought about them this year.
Yes.
Now, it's a tough game because...
You wouldn't have thought about Baby Spice this year.
I don't think I have. I think you would have won a hat for that.
Jack.
It was as good as my one last
week. Did I won a hat for you?
I haven't thought of her, but pretty sure Baby Spice was Emma.
Yeah, okay. We don't care.
You said Mel C.
Thanks, Spice Wiki.
Like, were you trying to get...
Nah, you know me, mate. Fast and loose. What do I care about facts?
I didn't even know you were having a go at it. I thought you were listing another one you haven't thought of for a while.
Right. Yeah, no.
Sorry, Jack. Yeah.
If people are getting...
correction.
Well done, Jack. I wonder what you do with all those screens over there. If people are listing, it kind of... I can see already we've got a full slide of calls here. 13, 10, 60, though, if you want to squeeze through.
Yeah.
But if people were thinking of Spice Girl...
Yeah, I wouldn't now.
That's the disaster about us having our own go every week.
Yeah.
Because sometimes we can just stumble upon one,
yes.
And then you're like, oh, yep, no, yep. That's they've said Chad Kroger, so that's he's out.
Hey, people, companies send in hats to our offices.
Who have we got today?
In a chance to be given away as the prize.
Yep.
What hat?
Well, last week, of course, the absolute booby prize, the scourge of all hats.
Yeah, the ghastly physio creme purple.
It's the opposite of the Holy Grail, I suppose, the poison chalice.
Yeah.
Was given away and is now being reluctantly worn around on someone's head. And we thank them for taking the boogie hat out of the system. So the physio creme hat is gone. If you missed last week's edition, definitely a podcast worth listening to. Very historic. Right up there with Hillary getting the nominee. Really historic day for the world, the physio creme hat went. Today, this is a rollover from last week as well. We discussed this hat last week. The Randwick City Council hat.
Not a bad one.
And
the reason why we like that one in there is you might get a chance to walk around Randwick. Very
pretty tough for a guy that sometimes struggle with Waskily Wabbit.
Walk around Randwick.
Yeah.
There's a new tongue twister.
Do it 10 times.
You've got a chance to walk around there and Randwick. and for people to think you actually contribute and work for the council.
If I lived in Randwick, this would be the hat I'd be gunning for. Or even a neighbouring council of Randwick.
Now that I think about it, though, what if you're having a bin complaint and you see someone with this hat on?
I'd just say, mate, this is a scam. I'm not a... I stole it. So I'm with you. I'm against the council. But then if I saw a council worker, say if you pull up, what if a ranger's trying to give you a ticket? You go, hey, mate.
Mate, I got the
same
hat
team.
On.
Yeah.
We're all same parking.
Team. Yeah, parking guy. Yeah. Move. Sorry, mate. Yeah. Same team. So
good
pretty good if you're keen to pretend to be an undercover council worker.
Yes.
Then we've got Retire Ready Financial Planning. Okay. Now, they have got... Sorry, I should have just mentioned it's a navy hat, the Randwick City Council one, and it's got...
White piping.
On the brim, which we do suspect is an additional extra when you're buying your promotional hats online in bulk by the 10,000.
The Retire Ready hat that you're holding up now, it's all white. But
baseball-y.
Flat brim. And you wouldn't have expected any retirees.
I think what they're trying
to have an American flat brim hat,
and they've kept the silver sticker on it.
Yeah,
like new era hats.
So a younger person might like that one.
I think what they're trying to do is go, hey, look, even hip people are retiring these days.
Yeah,
like we're not going to give you an old man driving hat yeah. as a promotional hat. We're going to give you a cool lid. Then Greyhound Adoption Program. Now, this is a classic hat.
Yes.
Because it's not showing off and it's not basic.
No.
They've opted for several extras for the Greyhound Adoption Program.
Yep.
And you and I know for a fact greyhounds have made terrific pets in the past. Our greyhound, Fred Bassett, he's part of the Greyhound Adoption Program.
Yes.
Green, crisp apple green brim.
Yep.
Off highlighted by a nice white head of the hat.
Yeah,
so if you're in an area where you want to have high visibility,
yep.
but advertise a dog-based adoption program,
yep.
this is the hat for you.
Slight off white.
It is a slight off white, but it's also they've also paid extra for several colours of embroidery. So you've got the logo there yep. on the side. You've got government sponsorship and all sorts of stuff.
And we're fond of the Greyhound Adoption Program, obviously getting racing greyhounds, finding them a home.
And
don't only go through three because no one needs more than say, this.
Like all the other hats do, they all do feature, and this is normal, the normal stitched air vent. Up the top of
yes.
there, so that all if you've got a hot head, fear not. Sometimes a very, very cheap hat might come without the event.
Hame, we're in the middle of tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while. If there's anyone out there, a celebrity that you think we haven't thought of since the beginning of this year,
you can win a hat.
You can win a hat. And Lachlan wants to do exactly that.
Ahoy, Lach, how are you?
Ahoy, boys.
Lachlan, big moment for you. We always like to ask people this. Now, if you've heard the segment before, have you been sitting on this one for a little while?
Yeah, I've had this one for a little while.
Yeah, good. Well, glad to get through. Best of luck with it.
This is your moment.
All right. So, Brendan Fraser from George of the Jungle.
Yeah, sorry, mate.
Yeah.
Nah.
What a pity.
Yeah. He's actually, I think he might have been on this this segment before.
He might have been too, but I was also talking to my wife about Encino Man the other day, which
yes, strangely enough, you and I have talked about Paulie Shaw a lot, and then when you describe Paulie
just an unlucky one, Locke, because yeah. we do talk about Brendan Fraser a fair bit. yeah. He's in our. We don't know a lot of. Yeah, you took it on the chin. Well done,
Matt.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy,
Matty. Who you got in the barrel?
All right, Lee Harding from Australian Idol.
Oh, bad luck.
Sorry. I bought his song Wasabi on iTunes as a joke.
Yeah.
Obviously. No, a good song. Because I was talking about it with a mate at dinner, and it's still one of the only songs I've bought on my phone in iTunes, so it always pops up.
Can you sing some of it, Hamish?
Can you stop singing like some as well?
Do you remember that song, Matt?
It's also Beck's dad's name. My girlfriend's dad's name is Lee Harding.
So
impossible. I think of him all the time. I mean,
regular.
Yeah.
On the regular.
Yeah.
Matt, it's a really unlucky one. this is
Jason.
This is Malcolm Turnbull. No, just read an article about him.
Jason,
who haven't you thought of for a while?
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy.
Annalise Brackensack.
It's two flags for me, all clear.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm going to give it to him.
Jace,
sorry, I was worried.
You heard the familiar pause of Pete, because obviously the human reaction is to go, well, I know who that is.
Yes.
Why haven't I thought of it?
Yes.
And then you go, I must have.
Yeah.
Well, I haven't. Can't pick it.
What happened, Jace?
Jace, well done. Congratulations. Were you an Annalise fan or just a lucky guess?
Randomly popped into my head the other day when I was listening to somebody else go, and I've gone, oh, I know a person.
Yeah.
And, yeah.
Well done. Good. Done, you've sat on it well, and the egg has hatched, and a hat has come out.
What hat, mate? Do you want the advantage of walking around the Randwick City Council with one of their hats, so you feel like one of their own? The retire ready flat brim baseball cap, or the Greyhound Adoption Program hat?
Boys, I'm in Queensland, so I think the Randwick hat's not going to be anything.
Yeah, that's out.
Yep.
I do.
Are you close to retiring, Jace? Do you want a retire ready hat?
Not even close, but I do like the idea of a flat cap. So
And you know what, Jason? It's actually not meant for you. Are you around people that might be retiring soon? Because you can't see your hat, and they can. So do you know anyone that's about 55?
You can wear it and invoke jealousy.
It's yours, Jace.
It's yours. And good choice.
You can do what you want with it.
Yeah, I mean, we talk about the Greyhound Adoption hat, but...
That would have been your pick?
I would have been my pick.
I don't like a bright white hat. I don't like an all white hat. I like my white hats to have a bit of something offsetting them. But personal.
Nicole, a chance for you to have a very rare second win in the one day. So the odds are against you.
But welcome to the show.
I've got you on this one.
Okay.
The Cause the group that sang the song Runaway.
No.
Sorry.
I was watching an episode of the UK Office the other night, and they mentioned, they were also talking about the hot girl violin quartet Bond the other week, and the cause came up for some reason in the same conversation as that.
Yeah. I mean, unlucky with the level that you and I reminisce here.
Yep.
But Nicole,
but also,
bad luck.
I feel like we were talking about Sinead O'Connor recently too, and the cause were mentioned in a kind of a Irish-like group. You know, we started mentioning at
Irish
least
groups.
Irish groups.
Damien Leith
with,
was also mentioned.
With lady singers. So, unlucky to Nicole, but certainly sit on it for next year. We might not think of them again, and we could be playing next year.
It's been a while since I've thought
about Garth Brooks.
Yeah. And it's been a while since I've seen them.
Slam dunk.
Yeah. I hadn't thought about Garth Brooks for a while. Good one.
Do you know Garth Brooks?
Nope.
He's a country and western singer from the 90s.
I know who he is, but
He is, I might have to double check this, but I'm pretty sure this is right, the highest selling male artist
of all time.
Yeah, I did know that. So, you know, you might not have thought about him for a while, but people know about him.
Yeah, they do.
They got him in their album collection.
In America,
yeah.
I reckon we wouldn't have got away with that.
People think about Garth Brooks daily.
Yes.
But no one here did. And that's why I just would have won a hat if I wasn't one of the hosts of the game in that simulation of tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
People, it's been voted 3 times running now, Australia's best and favourite play-along game in car or at home.
Yeah.
So that's nice that it came out of the car
category. Take that, Family Feud.
The way this game's played, though, for new listeners, welcome. We welcome all new people to the People's Show.
Welcome.
But 131060, just tell us someone we haven't thought about this year. Hamish and I do think about a lot of random people.
Now, there's
so be careful.
It's a tough game, obviously, as the year wears on. The pool of people we haven't thought about is going to shrink. Or more accurately, the pool of people we do think about expands.
Exactly. And if we have never known them.
Yep.
Bad luck. We can't have thought about.
Can't think
for a
about.
While.
That's one of the rules. Can't think about someone you don't know.
You win a hat. Hats are being sent in. A bit of a slowdown in the hat send-ins.
Well, we had a lot of wins last week, so I will and I know a couple of weeks ago I just closed the hat gate and I said, just stop it, guys. We got too many. We flushed the system a bit. Yeah. There was a mishap. In the office, because we have a charity box in the office.
No. Like, I wondered how we somebody had a shield.
We've accidentally sent about 30 hats to charity.
Well, this is nice.
Which is awesome.
Yep.
But it has reduced the pool.
Okay, what have we got today then?
And we've actually almost all every hat we had in the office had been featured, except these.
Okay, what are they?
Well, it's 3 Legionnaires hats.
Oh gosh.
From
this is the most disgusting round we've had.
From a company that specializes in Legionnaires hats, I think.
What's the company?
I think they're called Flapped or Get Flapped.
Yep.
So you've got a blue one, a kind of a
vomity color.
Vomity, mate. We don't want to put people off too badly.
Okay.
Look, I'd wear this. And then you got a kids one.
I'd wear them as a joke.
Look, sun protection ain't no joke, man. So you got. You can
put sunscreen on.
You can take a blue polka dot Legionnaire's hat.
That would be the preferred Legionnaire's hat.
I like the crazy pattern, and you got crazy pattern adult, crazy pattern
for
kid.
Kids. Okay.
And I do want to say, after our mishap of sending the ones to charity gear, send them in, figure it out. If you're a company, not a bad way to get your name out there, but beware, if you send us a bad promotional hat, you will be, shredded.
An honest assessment. We're in the middle of tell us someone we haven't thought about for a while. The chance to wear a hat that's been sent in here, and I want to fully retract what I just said.
There has been such a flip around
4 minutes ago
from today's hat prizes. Because
can I shock you?
We usually have a selection of different hats that are sent in from companies, you know, building companies, retirement, you know, dog adoption.
Yep.
There's no rules. Just send us in your promotional hat. Now, today's a bit different for 2 reasons. Number one, we accidentally gave away 30 hats to charity.
Yes.
We gave away our hat backlog because of where we put the hats and where our charity box is in the office. Mm. I'll take responsibility for that. Mm. Apologize. Second of all, the only ones that we had were ones that got delivered today, which are from actually a hat company. So it's not really a promotional hat, although their logo is on the front of the hat.
Yep.
They're a Legionnaire hat company called Get Flapped. Mm. So it's like a 5-panel hat with a flap on the back. I said I would wear this hat.
And you said they look ridiculous.
I did, and I off the shelf they did. But once on my head, I'm having the best time in the world. You and I are both in the hats now.
In fact, I would like to say to the company, you haven't sent in a promotional hat, but I wonder if you would. Would you make promotional Hamish and Andy hats for us as a team?
Yep.
Up to you. Mm. You have our address clearly. Next move is with you.
So Jack,
you're playing for a Legionnaire's hat, either a crazy pattern or a polka dot or a child's crazy pattern. How are you, Jack?
Ahoy there, boys.
Ahoy, mate. Anyone waiting online can head to our Snapchat. We've just put a picture up of the hats so you can have a look at the prize.
As part of our campaign, but I think to apologise.
You're better off focusing on the game,
not the reward.
Not the reward.
Jack, have you wanted to play the game for weeks, Jack? Sometimes people listen, they think they've got a good one, they want to get in.
Yeah. Well, been playing it for a bit now, and one of my mates actually plays it back with his schoolmates.
Okay.
About people they haven't thought of it for a while from their primary school days.
Yeah, that's good idea. It's nice to see, you know, a few subordinates to our major game happening here.
It's fun to see, more backyard versions of the game pop up. Jack, tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
Righto. So I've got two categories for you. Mm-hmm. You can choose which one. Ooh. So Olympic or novelty.
I'm going to give him the best chance of winning by saying novelty because I feel like...
I want to hear novelty anyway. So
I feel like, just from my perspective, I've been going back through a lot of Olympic footage recently.
Okay, great. Novelty, please, Jack.
Okay, novelty. Cartoon character, singer, schnappy, just climb a crocodile.
Well done. The German
crocodile who travels through Africa.
Well, Haim, you knew it. I don't even know it, so I'm out of this game.
Hang on. That could be a hat.
I thought if someone didn't know
it. Oh, no, sorry. Yes, I know it.
But Haim knows
it. I know who it is, but I haven't thought of it this year.
So he's got a hat?
Well, I mean, I'm just saying, I just wanted to make sure I had the right crocodile here, Jack. Is it the claymation one or like a cartoon one?
Yeah, it's the German singing crocodile who in the film clip travels through Africa. Snappy just climbed a crocodile.
I'm 1% aware of it.
Get Jack to play the song.
I don't know.
And for that, I'm giving you the win, Jack. I'm aware of that crocodile.
For a Cackling Jack's jibe, the fact that...
We're all on the fence. Someone had to make a decision.
Cackling Jack buzzed him twice.
I'm still giving him the win. Hey, Jack,
what hat do you want?
The Legionnaires hat.
Do you want the appalling rainbow vomit-coloured one or the light blue polka dots, Jack?
Polka dots.
Yes, smart. That comes off my head. It's my loss.
And he's been de-hatted.
And it's Jack's game. It's come off immediately, Jack.
Okay, Reese, quickly. Sorry, spent a lot of time with Jack. Reese, how are you, mate?
Ahoy, lad.
Ahoy, Reese. Tell us someone we haven't thought of in a while.
The first X Factor winner, Alfie and Charles.
Bad luck, my friend.
Andy has a poster of him on his wall. No, it's a really good guess, mate.
I don't have a poster of him on the wall, but the other day we were doing a competition with my mates and I. Who's fared better out of X Factor winners?
Yep.
Or voice winners or idol winners. We went through all three.
Yep.
And Altian was a plus for X Factor, which is lucky for him and that franchise.
Go, Zeddy, ahoy. Welcome to the show.
He went and lived in a cave.
Ahoy there, boys. How's it going?
Ahoy, Zeddy. Very good. Sorry, we're just covering off on Altian. He did live in a cave.
Yeah, went and lived in a cave for a weird time.
Inside.
Yes.
Inside a house, not a cave.
Zeddy. Tell us something we haven't thought about for a while.
Anastasia, he's saying, I'm out of love.
This is interesting.
Am I thinking of Shakira?
I am. So that's but I shouldn't be.
What's the difference between Anastasia and Shakira, apart from the fact they are different people?
Completely different. Yeah. Anastasia wore the purple disco sunglasses all the time.
It's a win for me.
I think it's a win for me too, Zeddy. Well done.
Apologies, Jack didn't have a clap sound effect there for you. There it is.
Right on time. Hey, Zeddy, there's only really one question. Do you want the adults or the children's get flapped Legionnaire's hat?
I'll take the adults one.
And it's a good pick.
Yeah, it's a good pick. It comes off Hamish's head.
We've both been de-hatted.
It's a double loss
huge
for us.
Round.
It's a huge round. Thanks very much for playing, Hamish and Andy.
It's been a while since I've thought
about Flathead from Home and Away.
Yeah, it's been a while since
Do you remember Flathead?
I remember what he looks like. He said Flathead.
Flathead, mate, the principal.
Oh, right. I mean, I never watched Home and Away.
So. And I've won. And it's as easy as that, guys. I mean, you know who he is, don't you?
Well,
oh, come on.
I mean no, Jack, you have...
Don't look at me. I don't know him.
Yeah.
Guys, so, he's up there with bloody Elf from Home and Away.
Well, he's not, because we know who Elf...
He's just under him, but he's up there. He's on the summit. Is he Sherpa?
Bobby.
Just under him. Was he Bobby's dad? Maybe. Look, he was an iconic 90s Home and Away guy. And the reason I like it so much is someone actually sent it in.
Sounds like you're trying to shirk the responsibility.
Well, that's the picture
I
was showing you from. It was on an Instagram direct message, which I never look at. Yep. And someone goes, I saw you the other day in the street, couldn't run across to see you, but please, it's been killing me. Sent me pictures saying Flathead, Home and Away, tell us something we haven't thought of for a while. I went, I'll pay that. That's good. Yep. I bet the other guys haven't thought of it, and I was right, and you would
ever. But we haven't thought of that guy ever.
Well, this just blows me away, Andy, because he's in the TV Hall of Fame.
Yeah. You could name everyone in the TV Hall of Fame.
Humphrey B. Bear, Flathead, Bert Newton, Bobby, also from Home and Away.
Bouncer, the dog from Davies.
Bouncer, the
and that's
dog.
Actually it.
Rove McManus and Andy Lee. Now, so you would have seen him in a meeting, which just goes to show how self-centered you are at those meetings. Just walking around, not even paying attention to the other guys, with blinkers on, and Flathead's there on the wall like a bloody bit of chopped liver. Well, that is just this real shame. This is
wouldn't
the
have
game,
been a win for me, but this is the game. The game is, tell us someone we haven't thought of this year. We have to specify to you when we've thought of them.
Yep.
And it's an honesty-based game. Hey, people.
I mean, that little bit of back and forth, the violence there, you know, that only it's only happening here because I'm pushing hard for Flathead, but it does have to be a team effort.
Yes. Hey, people send hats in, businesses send hats in, and that's what people are going to win. What have we got today?
And we've got three different types of hats.
Mm-hmm. Two Wallys, I've noticed.
Two Wallys. Mm. You can have a green one or a black one. This is from an early learning center.
Oh, yeah,
called the Green Elephant. So it's very stiff brim, and you feel the stiffness of that brim. And you
tiny
go,
head hat, is it?
Tiny head hat.
So it's a kid's hat?
Kid or a pinhead.
Yep.
You feel the stiffness of that brim. You go, that's what kids wear in playgrounds these days. Yep. We obviously went to primary school before mandatory hats.
Yes.
It's very foreign to us to have that stiff, a full-headed brim on a hat.
And you'd just say good quality?
Very good quality. Certainly
so kid's
sun-wise.
Or a
sun
needle
protection-wise.
Noggin.
Yeah, if you've got a little pea head, you could absolutely wear this.
Next hat.
So choice of green or black there. Classic. This is really something nice.
That is a good one, isn't it?
Snapback. Grey kind of carpet main hat. Black brim. Andrew's Hamburgers.
Oh, famous hamburger joint.
Really good. This, you can't fault this hat at all. A simple logo.
Yeah.
You could dress it up or dress it down.
If no one takes it, I might take it home.
Sure. Well, we actually sent a few, so got some spares at the office. You wear this to a formal event, wear this gardening, wash your car with it, go jet skiing with it.
All
first date, third date,
yep.
Wedding day, cricket, footy.
Yep.
Oh, it's not a great footy hat. We don't wear a lot of hats playing footy. So we discovered the only thing you couldn't use it for.
But if you did,
you'd pick that.
Yep.
Here we come to our third hat. It's black and orange, fluor orange.
My least favourite.
I don't like this hat.
No.
You hear the little bit of Velcro
at the back.
A lot of hat companies think they're doing the right thing with Velcro, but I find it a fiddly mechanism for the back of their head.
Exactly. It also frays easily over time.
Supergroups is the name of the company. We've got to give them a shout out. They have sent us a hat. I don't know who you are or what you do.
But you certainly haven't made a super hat.
But what you've done is you've made a hat that's too complicated for your own good. You've got two different layers of
white
density.
White piping in the middle.
Your piping's all over the place. Your colours are all over the place.
A horrific orange.
It seems shallow for the head.
It does
seems to have a shallow amount of cranium space. So you've made a shallow, confusing, overcomplicated hat. Wish you the best.
I wouldn't recommend it. We'll go to a song.
Thanks for that.
And after this, people will try and tell us celebrities of the past or known people from the past if we haven't heard of them or thought of them for a while.
Like a flathead or something.
We'll award them a hat of their choice. Haim, we are in phase two of tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while. There are some hats up for grabs of various quality. I'd say one of our best hats we've ever received.
Highest quality and most confusing. And just someone panicking, I think, on the order form.
when you get to design your own promotional hat. Yeah. I assume it falls to someone in the office, mate, bang us up a hat.
It's
and,
not.
And on the surely the company goes, where do you want the piping? Do you want colours? And they've just said yes to everything. It's an overproduced, confusing hat.
It's still not the new groups. Physio creme hat.
It's not as bad as physio creme,
but
obviously.
Because that was
a 100-year storm.
That, yeah, also
will never be as bad.
The physio creme, number one physio for cremes.
Yeah, always number one creme in the world.
Sorry, creme for physios.
Pain relieving
but,
creme.
Yeah, but they also wear just bog cheap. It feels like this has actually cost a bit.
This is like when
disgusting.
Homer Simpson designed a car. It cost a fortune, and it's sent his brother broke. Poor Herb, we feel for you. Whoever financed, whichever Herb financed this hat, we feel for you. The other hat we've got is the broad-brimmed Early Learning Centre, the green elephant hat. Really good. It's a child's hat, or if you've got a pea head or a pinhead.
Yep, and the Andrew's hamburgers.
Andrew's hamburgers.
Certainly
hat.
Top quality. That's Cade on 13 10 60. Tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
Boys, I don't think there's any chance you've thought of Nelly Furtado this year.
Oh, we do sing her song a lot.
I have.
Okay.
I'm afraid.
Jeez, it was good, Cade.
The reason I'll say this is because...
I was close to a green light there.
Yeah, Beck, my ex-girlfriend, their dog, when they were throwing around names...
Is like a bird.
No, it's not like a bird.
Her hit song.
It's called Nelly.
Yep.
And so we discussed it at that point when they named the new dog about 3 months ago.
I will often name foods in the kitchen, and I'm pretty sure I've thrown out Nelly Potato.
Cade, bad luck. Well played. Alex.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Al. Before you get to the hat gift shop, you do need to tell us someone we haven't thought about in a while.
I reckon Mark Mitchell, you know, Mr. Gribble from Round the Twist.
Yeah, and Con the Fruiterer.
Con the Fruiterer, that's the one.
Yeah.
Does it count if I've thought of Con the Fruiterer?
No, I said Mark Mitchell at the start.
Well, then, it is a green light for me, Alex, if you're going to get me on that technicality, because I reckon I thought of Con the Fruiterer, but I haven't thought about him enough for my brain to go, remember, that's Mark Mitchell.
It's a go for me.
Okay,
it's a go for
you
me.
Got it.
I think he's
green light.
Yeah. You got it.
You're dancing with danger, Alex, because until late last year, he was the voice of radio.
Yes, he does all the radio ads. And I remember,
but I was thinking, I haven't thought of him since then.
Yeah, I remember on December 30 last year going, for next year, I'm going to free up some brain space and I'm going to stop thinking about Mark Mitchell and only his characters. Alex, what hat do you want?
Probably the biggest one you got. I've got a bit of a melon head there.
Oh, well, that rules you out
the
of
the Andrew's hamburger
yeah,
hat.
Yeah, it's the best hat that we got,
Super
mate.
Groups is too shallow. You got the Andrew's hamburgers hat, Alex.
Ah, oh, thank you.
It's a really good one, Alex. You should be really proud. Well done. It's the gold medal of hats.
Perfect.
Congratulations, Lucas. Now, Lucas, tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
Ahoy, gentlemen, happy birthday and
yes, thank
birthday
you.
Birthday year.
Don't do birthdays, Lucas.
Well, you made us celebrate your birthday week and month, so it is your birthday year. Lucas, who haven't we thought of for a while?
The band Faker.
Faker,
unfortunately, it's a no from me.
Tough for bands. Yes. Andy often thinks of bands.
The reason being, Lucas,
most bands each day.
They have a song called Heart Attack, wasn't it?
This Heart Attack.
Yeah, This Heart Attack. My dad had a heart attack week that song came out, and so often... we bring that up, the fact that Faker caused my dad a heart attack to him and within my family.
Lucas,
and Faker haven't apologised yet.
Looking back on it, it seems like an obvious, you should have seen that coming.
Yes.
But do you have another one, Lucas? Not for today, but will you call back and play again?
Absolutely not.
Once bitten, twice shy.
Lucas.
Long time listener, first time caller, and don't expect me back again, guys, because you've let me down.
Lucas, obviously, he played his best hand, Ham, and he's not going to go back. He's officially retiring from the game.
And that happens to a lot of people that play the game, too. They have a shot on goal, it goes wide, then they jog to the bench, keep jogging, hit the showers, clean themselves, go home, and the game's still happening.
And never
at the play stadium.
Again.
I appreciate your honesty, Lucas.
Time for this.
It's been a while since I've thought
about that band, Area 7.
Pretty good.
Yeah. And it's been a while since I've seen them.
You get me with most bands, though.
Yeah.
Bands? But you would have got a hat.
I would have got a hat.
This is Tell Us Someone We Haven't Thought Of In A While. Tough game to play because you're going up against myself and Andy's personal experience. Mm. So what might seem... to you, an obvious person you think we wouldn't have thought of for a while, sometimes to us, is very obvious. Let us just say we have thought of Lee Harding, who sings Wasabi from Australian Idol.
Plenty of times.
We've thought of, who's the other one we always get? Nikki Webster.
Nikki Webster.
Nikki Webster and Lee Harding have been thought of. Do not call for Lee Harding and Nikki Webster. You got to be cleverer.
Hey, Ham, hats to get sent in, and we're going to rip through these today. Hats get sent in. They're the prizes. What companies?
Ando, International Cargo Express, ICE. Not the best acronym at the moment. ICE, I mean, doesn't always mean a bad thing.
Yep.
Can sometimes. Anyway, ICE have sent in just a plain blue.
Looks quite nice, actually.
Really good. I don't have a problem with this at all.
White piping.
I don't love the fastener at the back. It's one of my least favourites. The
buckle.
It's the fabric buckle. Mm. But you've got a nice white piping on the beak there. Not really showing off on the cap. There's no stitching on the bill.
Mm.
But you'd wear that in the garden.
Top 20% all of hats would have been sent in.
You wouldn't wear it going out, but you would wear it definitely driving or in the garden.
Yes.
Football, Far North Coast Football Federation.
Yep, don't like this one.
This is an overcomplicated cat.
Too much, yep.
You've got the logo, then your piping's all over the spot. Yep. You've got speed stripes running down the middle of the brim.
Yep.
They've attached a note.
It's a Eurovision type outfit, just going for way too much.
The good thing is, though, it's got a bit of history to it. Yeah, okay. They won the point score contest. It's got point score champions 2012 on the side. So it's an older hat.
Yep.
It's a used hat. Hey, boys, there's a note on it, which is just written on a bit of news agent bag.
They've ripped
the bag apart. Hopefully someone's able to wear this 2012 point score champions cap with pride.
Yeah. Well, I wouldn't.
Yep.
I'm taking nothing away from winning the point scoring, but the hat is substandard.
Here's another hat from a region. If you're a roadie or you like sort of plain black fashion hats, this is for you. Feels like a slightly softer fabric, more almost a felt, like a short felt.
It's a limp top, isn't it?
It's a limp top. It's not reinforced the way others are. It's got a Velcro backing, my second bottom least of the range favorite.
Yep.
It's
what's it say on the front?
Make Kalinga great again. With the Donald Trump, in the Donald Trump style of Make America Great Again. Kalinga, of course, just north of Brizzy on your way out to the Sunshine Coast. I like it. I got to say, at first I was spooked.
Yes.
But it's really grown on me, and I'm almost going to give it pick of the hats today.
Wow. That's Hamish's
top dollar.
Pick of the hats.
Top dollar.
Tell us something we haven't thought of for a while. Call in now. 131060 is the number. Michelle.
Hey, boys. Ahoy.
Ahoy to you. Ahoy, tell us something we haven't thought of for a while.
Well, I know I've got this one. Ooh. Drop Dead Fred.
Drop Dead Fred.
Drop Dead Fred.
The character.
The character, yeah.
We do accept characters.
Jeez.
I have.
You have?
Yeah, he's an imaginary friend, isn't he, Michelle?
He certainly is.
It's chained to Ryan, our mate Ryan, about it the other day. About just how you don't hear about imaginary friends much anymore. And Ryan goes, Ryan was talking
Michelle,
about.
Michelle, bad luck.
Sorry, but, Michelle. Ryan mentioned Drop Dead Fred, so blame him.
Beck on 131060. Who are you going for?
Ahoy, boys. Ahoy. I think you haven't thought of Nev Campbell.
Nev Campbell, unfortunately not.
Andy's got the Wild Things poster on his bedroom wall.
No, she returns in House of Cards.
Oh, yeah, she's in House of Cards.
She's in House of Cards. She's actually House of Cards, a very, very popular season with Kevin Spacey. She's actually in the latest season of that.
Have you seen House of Cards, Beck?
No, I haven't.
Yeah. See it. She's quite a sassy power broker.
But I was surprised when I saw her. I was like, oh, there's
a great return, though. Great return.
Yes, she's caught me.
I forgot that I'd seen that, watched that whole season, so I've seen her for literally hours this year.
Michaela,
ahoy, welcome, and tell us something you don't know. Oh, I mean, we don't know and haven't thought of for a while, but we do know them. You know this. You know the name of the. You know it.
I'm going for Luke Perry.
Oh, bad luck.
Beverly Hills.
Yeah, no. Think about him daily.
Yeah, Andy thinks about him daily. Andy often refers to himself. I've heard Andy whisper to himself in the mirror. There you are, you young Luke Perry.
Not true.
I've heard you whisper it.
But we always talk about the Andrea conundrum.
Yes, the Andrea phenomenon, where I had a crush on Andrea because I thought she was more gettable.
And that
she would appreciate the attention.
Often speaks to me. I start thinking of the whole group.
The whole cast.
Yes.
Okay, yep.
Jose.
I'm thinking Tamara Jaber.
Bad luck again.
It's a pretty good guess. I mean, Kyle Sanderland's ex-wife.
Yes. But can I tell you, they spoke about Tamara Jaber yesterday.
It's a good guess. It's a great guess.
I'll tell you why, Ham, is because someone said to me, because I played a band with my brother, why don't you get your music played on the station? And my brother said, oh, we don't want to Kyle Sanderland's it. with Tamara Jaber. And I went, right.
Referring to when he was throwing his weight around to get her record plate.
Yes.
Yep.
So as recently as 24 hours ago, I...
Wow. No one saw you mentioning Jaber within the last 24 hours.
Jamie, no hat has gone today. What are your thoughts?
Tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while, Jamie.
Aristos the chef.
Oh, pretty good.
He's got it!
Pretty good. Yeah, Jamie.
Remind me of what Aristos, the name.
Wasn't he surprise chef?
He was the surprise chef, was he?
Was Aristos the surprise chef?
I can't even remember. No, I just remember the name.
It's a surprise to us. Remember the name.
I think he would sneak up to people in the supermarket and go, what do you got?
Yeah, that's him.
Come on, I'm coming to your house. And they go, oh, no, that's okay. No, I'm coming to your house. No, seriously, I've got people coming over. I don't know who you are. And he'd budge over to their house and he'd cook them up a meal. And in the end, he would always win them over. As you won us over, Jamie, what hat do you? What hat would you like from the gift shop, Jamie?
Any that you choose.
Well, you've got no, your choice. You've got the black.
I mean, we wouldn't wish the red one on anyone, so that's out of the mix. Haim, the black one from...
I reckon a good middle of the road, nice safe hat is the blue International Cargo Express hat, Jamie.
Yeah. That's the one I wanted.
Yeah. You've got it. You got it. You're going to look...
Thank you, Jamie. Well played.
You're going to look stunning.
Well, stay on the line. I'm going to send that out to you.
Hamish and Andy.
I'm ready.
It's been a while since I've thought
about Mikhail Gorbachev.
Yeah.
And it's been a while since I've seen them.
Yeah, really good.
Thank you.
That's a really good one.
Thank you, guys.
For younger listeners, Mikhail Gorbachev was the leader of the USSR.
Yes, pre-breakup of the Soviet Union.
Yes.
He sort of negotiated that, and that's where my knowledge runs out.
Famous for having obviously being a world leader, but having a birthmark on his shiny bald forehead.
Yeah. So I would have won a hat there because we're playing Tell Us Someone We Haven't Thought About for a while. And we, Frando and I, we do still classify that as this year. So obviously it gets harder and harder every week, but I feel like our players get better and better every week.
Yep.
No longer are we just getting people saying Nikki Webster or Lee Harding from Australian Idol who sung the hit song Wasabi. We know about those two. We think about them on the reg because they're always thrown up for this. We also know about Steve Urkel and Joey Jeremiah.
Haim. Talk us through the hats today. Companies can send in your hats to the station and they become the prizes, meaning obviously cost to us of a postage of the hat.
Well, I mean, you've got the chance to win a hat here. The hats are promotional hats. Sutton Tools has chucked us a hat. Really nice sky blue.
Yeah.
You don't see a blue of that quality on a hat very often.
With a design on the peak, which I'm normally nervous about, don't mind this one.
I tell you, there's a couple of positives, a couple of negatives for me. I like the Sutton Tools logo because I believe that's just italic Arial font.
Mm-hmm.
Sutton bold, Tools regular. Mm-hmm. That's nice and simple. That's in white embroidery on the front of the hat. I like they've paid for embroidery. That's expensive when it comes to hats. On the brim, then I start to get nervous because it's a blue brim with white decals on it.
Yep.
And you and I in this segment, one of our pet hates is over-decorating the brim of your hat.
Yeah.
So many companies seem to go for it for such little effect, I feel. I'll give them a pass.
Yeah, I agree.
Because it's not too crazy. And they haven't changed material on the peak of the cap. A lot of people, I think, just panic and put two or three different thicknesses on the brim.
Exactly.
That's where they lose me.
Or a wiki design. This seems pretty much regimented. You know?
Seems streamlined, almost as if it's been carved by some Sutton Tools.
Okay.
on the back, not my favourite fastener. You've got Velcro and the website above the ventilation bit at the end of the back.
Nice hat.
Not bad.
Nice hat.
Here we go. Nice plain black hat. It's a flex fit.
We haven't had many flex fits.
And who are these guys? Someone Golf Tours.
All right.
Starts with an S. Oh, Signature.
Okay.
Signature Golf Tours, because they've written the signature as a signature and it's almost impossible to read.
Okay.
It's not doing its job as a promotional hat.
No.
You'd be into this, Anna. You'd wear this out. You've probably been on a tour with Signature.
I haven't, but I look forward to one.
That's a nice plain black hat. You've got the golf ball there in silver.
Yep.
And that's an eye-catching golf ball. Very big.
You could wear that forwards or backwards.
You dress that up or dress it down.
But not on the golf course backwards.
I could. and here, as blue as the Sutton Tools hat was, the decor hat is red.
Oh, yeah.
Decor, I believe, make plastics, your Tupperware
right
kind of gear. Again, really simple logo.
Mm-hmm.
Basic embroidery in white.
Yep.
Real forceful red
hat. Seems a bit like a limp hat.
I don't love the structure of the upper.
It seems a little limp, and a Velcro fastening that doesn't seem to be a week.
A week of Velcro there. And then at the back, it has proud sponsor of the Richmond Football Club. Ooh. Now, guys, that seems a bit braggy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, either put their logo up there, or if you have sponsored them and you're on the Guernsey, let that do the talking. You don't have to go around bragging about some relationship you've got with Richmond on the back of your hat.
And I'd save some money on sponsoring Richmond, who haven't gone very well, and put some more money into your hat.
Why don't you get a better fastener? Why don't you get a better fastener? Still, like the front, like your font, and I like your colour. So, there you go. There are today's hats.
Time for Tell Us Someone We Haven't Thought Of For A While, Ham, where people call up on 13 10 60 and they tell us someone that they think we haven't pondered about, or have they even entered our mind in the last 7 months.
Essentially, you got the choice of three hats. Sutton Tools, that's your blue hat. Decor, that's your red hat. Signature Golf Tours, that's your black flexi fit.
What's your favourite?
Great question.
I think the flexi fit of the signature.
I think it is because I want to wear it on the golf course. I want to wear it backwards.
You're not allowed.
I know it'd upset you.
Fran joins us. Tell us someone.
I am allowed.
We haven't thought of for a while.
Ahoy. Ahoy, Fran. Who haven't we thought of for a while?
Dave Dobbin.
Oh, yeah, no, Slice of Heaven. Sorry, I sing it a lot. Sorry.
You sing it like a robot, don't you?
Sorry, Fran.
Yep.
Big song at our house. Sonny loves it.
Okay.
Bad luck,
sorry,
friend.
Mate. That's the game. Try and get through again, and good luck with that
next time.
Ebony.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Ebony. Who do you reckon we haven't thought of for a while?
Fitting with your introduction, Murat Safin.
Murat Safin.
The tennis player.
Yeah. I mean, you're in prime turf for people I haven't thought of for a while. I usually go to bed at night and I've got all the world-famous lacrosse players up on my wall and I say goodnight to them, but I don't have...
It's a yes from me.
And it's a yes from me, Ebony.
Well done, Ebony!
We have not thought of Murat Safin this year.
I think he won an Australian Open back in the day.
I think you're thinking of Mats Wilander.
No, I'm not. I'm thinking of Murat Safin.
No, you're thinking of...
Murat Safin.
Roger Federer.
Ebony, what hat would you like?
To be honest, I missed most of it.
That's all right.
It was a bit patchy.
We were too quick, I think, discussing the hats. It does happen. So you've got a blue Sutton's Tools hat, a bright red decor hat. I think they make plasticware.
Or a black signature golf hat, but it's a flexi fit.
Golf Tours. Yeah, that's a flex fit hat. So a bit of a lucky dip with flex fit. It's a small to medium.
Oh, I might go the red one. It might make me... protected from the sun faster.
Oh, good work, Ebony. The red hat's yours. It's a bit of a limp hat. Wasn't my favourite, but it goes out the door.
Certainly
very much
the
for playing.
Front half of the hat is far superior to the back, which is a bit lifeless. You've got it, Ebony!
Okay, well done. Sam, tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Sam.
Happy birthday, Andy.
Thank you, Sam. Thanks for taking the load off us. He's always making us talk about his birthday.
Sam. Yes, Sam. Well done. And tell us who we
are. I was thinking George Garcia.
Who's George Garcia?
Who is George Garcia?
So he was Hector off Lost.
Oh.
Program Lost.
Yep.
Sorry. I never saw Lost, I'm out.
Sam, unfortunately this does happen. We can't give it to you just because we didn't know who George Garcia
know who he is.
Yeah. So he was he Hurley off Lost? He was big
Hurley, that's the guy, yeah.
I mean, I know him, but I never knew his name was George Garcia.
So Sam, well played.
Well played. You're very, very close. And one day a hat could be yours. Belinda, ahoy Belinda.
Ahoy, boys. Happy birthday, Andy.
Thank you so much, Belinda. Lay it on thick, and maybe he'll give us a rest.
Belinda, tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
I'm thinking Bill Oddie from The Goodies.
Unfortunately, no. It's a no for me. Hamish and I, well, you and I do talk about getting a bike for you, me, and Jack.
Yeah, like The Goodies.
Like The Goodies. Again, this is a late 80s TV show, British one.
What a great choice, though, Belinda. Well done. You weren't to know we talk about Bill Oddie a lot from The Goodies.
but yes, for younger listeners, exceptional biking from them. They could all ride at the same time.
And one of their best talents. Dan, ahoy. You're Our last gasp at a hat here.
Ahoy, boys. I'll have a dig at it.
Yep.
I would want to take you back to the Wonder Years. I'd like to say Fred Savage.
Bad luck. I've thought of Fred.
Unfortunately, Dan, Kevin Arnold and Jason Biggs are the two people I often say Andy looks a lot like.
Yes.
Yes. Both step-ups for Andy, yeah. But certainly his closest lookalikes on television.
James Franco is also mentioned.
Not by anyone outside of your head.
Jimmy, we've got time for one more.
Let's go, Jimmy. Let's go, Jimmy.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Jimmy.
Happy birthday, Andy.
Thank you, Jimmy.
Good on you, Jim.
All right, boys, I'm going to go with Tim McGraw, the country western singer.
No.
Tim McGraw.
How have you heard of Tim McGraw?
Good on you, Jimmy. A challenge.
Isn't he married to Gwen Stefani?
That was Gavin Rossdale, wasn't it?
No, and then she's since back.
She's gone to Tim McGraw.
Was married to Faith Hill.
Come on, Cackling Jack, get it up.
Okay, I mean, I feel like Tim McGraw recently did a duet
now
with Gwen Stefani.
Okay, are you sure you're not thinking of when I mentioned Garth Brooks?
No, it's not Garth Brooks. This is some big... Thank you, I need some timping.
Jimmy, it's a yes from me. I don't think I've thought of Tim McGraw this year.
Tim McGraw and Faith Hill, they're together.
Oh, mate... Jimmy, what I'm seeing here is the scrambling of a desperate man who, for some reason, doesn't want to give you a hat. Andy, you look me in the eye and you tell me you have thought of Tim McGraw this year. Look me in the eye. Can you? He can't, Jimmy. He's not looking at me.
I'm not looking
at you. Andy, you look me in the
eye. Sorry. Cut the music. Country act Blake Shelton is married to Gwen Stefani.
You look at me.
Yep. And I have not been... I've been thinking of Blake Shelton
this whole time.
And not been thinking of Tim McGraw.
Jimmy.
You've got yourself a hat. Which one do you want, buddy?
Great.
I want that golf one. I want to hit up the links with Andy. Let's do it, boys.
Yeah, okay. We will do that. Jimmy, be sure to wear it forward. We'll get in trouble if you wear it backwards.
Well done, Jimmy. And amazing persistence, too. He believed he had the win and he stuck in there and he earned it.
Time for...
It's been a while since I've thought
about Ben Mendelsohn. No, I can't. I mean, is that any good?
Ben Mendelsohn.
I panicked. I had one and I forgot. I'm so sorry.
It would have been a fail for me because Ben Mendelsohn's been doing some...
Yeah, I've thought about him heaps too.
Terrific work. The other thing is he looks like...
But I wasn't thinking of Ben Mendelsohn. I had one that was like Ben Mendelsohn.
Yeah.
And I forgot it just as the music started, and that's why I panicked and went, well, I have to say a name.
Yeah.
I know I've lost and I haven't succeeded. We are playing, for those that don't know what this is, it's tell us someone we haven't thought about for a while. Mm. Where the goal is to mention a well-known personality that Andy and I haven't thought about this year.
Yep.
Obviously, we've thought about Ben Mendelsohn. Big fan of his work.
And that, who was I thinking of? It's okay. It's okay. Let's go into the hat.
This is how hard the game is, though. Yes. I mean, I've just shown you how easy it is to fail. But can we win? If you do win, you've got a chance. If you can name someone 13, 10, 16
that we haven't thought about this year.
Tell us someone that Andy and I can honestly say we haven't thought about this year. And if we have thought about them, we usually do require ourselves to give you an example of when and where we thought about them. Mm. But if you sneak one through, then congratulations. You will have won one of the promotional hats sent in by companies Australia-wide. A lot of hats coming in. We do encourage people to keep them coming in because you never know if your hat will get picked out of the box. Today, the lucky winners are really nice basic orange.
Love it. Real Dutch orange for people who...
Perfect description. Yeah. Possibly a shorter bucket, lower volume than I'd like in a baseball cap, but I won't hold it against them too much.
Shallow cap.
High quality grey engraving. I like the orange and grey. Mm-hmm. Gunmetal grey.
Embroidery or is it?
Embroidered, you bet. Not an iron on. Yeah. So it's fabric all the way around. Pure orange. Yep. Orange peak, orange hat, orange nib on the top. Velcro.
Not our favourite.
Second least favourite. Fastener. But that's well done. Okay. I mean, it's a good solid orange hat. You got 8 stitches along the peak.
Beautiful.
Well made hat.
Next
That's Bloom Hearing Specialists is the logo there. Don't know what they do, but I am guaranteed something to do with hearing. And they specialise in it. Yeah. And the next hat, I got a love-hate with.
Okay.
It cannot be denied it's a cheap hat.
Yes.
I mean, you look at the fabric there. Yep. That's flimsy fabric. It would hold up to, I reckon, 2 powerful sweats.
Yep.
If you played tennis in this twice, you'd start to see it falling apart.
It'd perish.
Now, it's a very short-brimmed hat, too. So even from... Look at that.
Look at the difference in brims.
Yeah, that's a, and then they've gone for too much detailing on the peak, haven't they?
And it's sort of a shiny polyester kind of material. Wouldn't breathe. It's got breathable holes in it, but wouldn't breathe. I don't think the fabric could breathe or absorb sweat.
Velcro fastener.
Velcro, that's the least of its problems. Look at the peak.
Yeah.
Look at the peak. No stitching on the peak. So the material is already bubbling on the peak
on the
in
inside.
The curve. Yeah. And it's reminiscent of a toy you'd get at the show.
Mm.
It looks fine for now the carny's tricking you, but once you got home, you'd realize you have been tricked.
And what company sent that one in?
Piping and Automation Systems, PAAS. It's a black hat with a white logo. And this is where the love-hate comes into it. Yeah. I love it because I don't know what Piping and Automation Systems do.
Yeah.
I assume they do it very well.
Yes.
My father, as you know, worked as an irrigation specialist for his professional life. He was into piping, and he was certainly into automated systems.
Mm.
So, I'm torn.
That's why you like
it. I don't want to slag off the industry.
He also loves hats.
He loves hats. So, this hits him where it hurts.
Okay. It's not the best hat, but the final one, Ham, because we've got to keep moving.
The logo, though, is sort of in NASA font.
Mm.
Great hat. Trucker. Basic trucker. We love a trucker.
Yep.
You've got navy blue mesh, white front, navy peak.
Yep.
High quality trucker, because as you can see, the very, very thin rope that goes around the base of the front. This is from a company called Mosey Peninsula.
Okay, what are they up to?
It's our first custom hat, Ando. They've had it printed for this game.
Really?
On the front of the hat, it says, seems neither Hamish or Annie had thought of that person this year. Well done. Mosey Peninsula app is for the Mornington Peninsula and comes out this summer.
That's
so
great.
It's a hat that references the segment and gives a little forward nod to when this app comes out.
Well, that'd be the trophy for this week,
I mean, don't everyone start doing it now because we won't mention it again.
No.
But for the first person that has ever custom made a hat for this segment, we take
besides Physiocrem that made that stupid sequence hat that was more disgusting than...
Oh, we don't talk about Physiocrem anymore. World's number one creme, number 5 millionth hat.
Dunce hat. Daisy on 131060, tell us something we haven't thought of for a while.
Ahoy.
Ahoy, Daisy. I can hear you. I can tell you're nervous. Mm. And
just relax.
So you should be, because when there's a hat on the line, you don't want to fluff it. And have you been thinking of this person for a while to enter into the... Yeah, we get that a lot. Okay, good luck. Play your trump card, Daisy.
Thank you. Mark Viduka.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry, Daisy.
Yes, so sorry. He actually went to one of my friend's schools.
That's true.
And my friend was coaching the soccer team. Mark Viduka was coaching the opposition soccer team. It was the grade 3s and 4s. I heard that story more recently. We talked about it.
And he's, knows someone that's had eyes on
The Duke.
MV.
He's a soccer player from the past for people who don't know who Mark Viduka is.
But a great try, Daisy, and try again another week.
Yeah, Lauren.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy. Ahoy, Lauren. Who haven't we thought of in a while?
Sister, the musical duo from the 90s.
S2S, unfortunately, thought of them.
Oh, Andy, really?
Yeah. Andy will think pretty much of any all-girl group at least once a week.
Not true. Oh.
Very true.
S Club 7 came out more recently.
Did they?
And played at the hotel around the corner from us.
Did they?
Did they?
What were they doing there?
Yeah, I know. And my brother and I were talking about what would be the next band to bring out to that hotel in S2S.
So sorry, Lauren. Checks out.
Jess.
Jess, ahoy.
Hi, how you going?
Yeah, really good, Jess. Tell us someone we haven't thought about.
Jane Seymour.
Who's Jane Seymour?
Dr. Quinn, medicine woman.
Oh, no, sorry. Yeah. False start. I mean, I thought you meant Jane Austen, who I have thought about, but I couldn't remember. But
that's great.
God, I haven't thought of Dr. Quinn, medicine woman. Yeah, you're right.
You've got it, Jessie.
I know who she is. You've got it, Jessie.
Well played.
Well done. The doctor is in our minds now. Jess, what do you
Which
want?
Hat?
What hat?
The trucker hat, please.
You want the trucker hat?
Yeah, good choice.
Really good choice. Thought that would be snapped up.
Yes. Definitely avoid the PAPS one.
Well, and it's not PAPS. It's PAAS. It's
PAS.
Piping and Automation Systems. Again, if you're in that industry, they might be,
that might be great.
A huge deal in the industry.
But it's just not a great hat.
It isn't a great hat. It's not going to hold up to a solid sweat. But if you're a low sweater, you might like the hat. Tim,
do you sweat a lot?
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, Tim, it's probably not the hat for you. You probably want to be looking at the orange bloom hearing specialist hat if you're successful.
I just need to say happy birthday to Annie as well.
He appreciates it, mate. I'm getting a bit sick of him forcing us to make a big deal of his birthday, but he loves your best wishes. Tim, who haven't we thought about for a while?
I'm going to go Mika.
That's good. You reckon?
Grace Kelly?
Yeah, I know. We know him.
Unfortunately for Tim, it's one of the key lookalikes that's sent in.
For you.
No. For me.
Jason yeah. Biggs, Kevin Arnold, Mika.
James Franco.
Not Mika. True. Never heard James Franco. Yeah, Tim, he does.
Damn it.
People do think Andy looks like Mika, so, which is a huge insult to Mika.
I'm reminded of that online rather regularly. Tim, it was a good one. Damn it, Tim.
You weren't to know, Tim, yeah. that Andy spends up to an hour a day looking in the mirror, trying to pull his hair back and sing the lyrics to Grace Kelly yeah, to yeah. see if he has a career as a lookalike.
Big Girls, You Are Beautiful is the other one I like to sing at home while pretending to be Mika, two of his songs from the past.
A valuable insight, but a loss of a hat. Only one hat going off today. Well played, everyone.
Ham, time. Oh, actually, Jack, you're going to be singing, aren't you?
I got a great one coming off email.
Great. All right.
Tell
great.
Someone this... we haven't thought of.
Go for it, bud.
It's been a while since I've thought
about Kevin Federline.
Yeah, and it's been a while since I've seen them.
Can we?
I think well, it's.
Can we give that to Jack? I know I have thought of him, but how? How I have I thought of him?
I think it would have got me.
No, I got big red flags for me. Because weren't we talking about the TV show?
Oh yeah.
Like that celebrity fat camp.
Yeah, yeah.
Celebrity slim down.
Yeah.
Fat camp's probably a bit rough.
Wasn't
celebrity slim down.
Wasn't like, called that either. But
Merv Hughes. Excess baggage.
Excess baggage.
yes.
Merv Hughes was up. We were talking about that the other day. And K-Fed came out to do it.
Yeah, you're right.
So
still
sorry,
not
Jack.
A bad one, Jack.
Not a bad one. That is the game. Tell someone we have not thought of.
For a while.
And that pretty much for us means still this year. So
yes.
You've got to name a household name, a well-known personality that you reckon Andy and I haven't thought of for a while. If we can prove we have, as you just heard, you will not win. If you do win, you will win one of the promotional hats that people have been sending in all week.
Great.
We're snowed under. Now it's hard to get on.
Okay.
So still send them in because it is great fun if your hat makes it on. But we do have a ton of hats, but send them in. I'll burn through them here because I know we've got to keep this short. Bright orange. We're talking Dutch orange.
Yep.
Really like the color. Not quite high-vis orange, but fairly orange. G.I.J.
And it looks What's like that? A trumpet
And
on
it does
the J.
look like You wish, mate. That's a saxophone. Nah, it's a trumpet. Well done. You've got it. The J is sort of in the shape of a trumpet. Don't let that put you off if you're anti-trumpet. It stands for Generations in Jazz. I think they're a club or a group that
like
I think the idea is bring your mum, bring your dad, bring your
kids.
The
only thing letting it down is the Velcro fastener at the back.
Velcro fastener. Can't say this enough. And everything's got a Velcro fastener today. I really want to see a real cutout in Velcro fasteners. They're my least favourite fastener. It's too flimsy, especially in a high wind situation. Doesn't matter. What have we got for our last two hats? I'll sort of lump them together because they're pretty similar. Might have even been from the same company. On one hand, we've got Rhino Solar modular panel systems.
Yep.
Who are you going to trust with your solar? Up to you, but Rhino Solar should definitely be involved in the conversation. Next, we've got Ink Sports Nutrition. A lot of products out there. Can't vouch for Ink. Can't vouch against him, though.
Can I quickly
Here's the big
say
diff.
This.
Here's the big diff
for me. I would say...
Under peak color.
Yep.
They're black hats. They're both black hats with essentially a white logo on the front. What do you want? You want Rhino Solid? You want Ink Sports Nutrition? But there's a red peak on Ink Sports Nutrition. And we see the peak showing off, trying to do too much. The peak.
But the Ink Sports, whatever it's called, has got a better logo than the...
You don't like Rhino Solar?
Rhino Solar. I would say better logo, but there's less jazz going on the peak.
You have to be comfortable being the guy that's wearing a fancy peaked cap. What's essentially a plain black hat with white embroidery. It then has kind of a half red top of the bill and a full red underneath. If you think you can pull it off, by all means, 13 10 60, tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while. Your chance, if you're the first person to win, you get the selection of the hats, and obviously as we go down the winners, you get the dregs.
In the middle of tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while, running a bit behind, so let's jump straight into it, Ham. There's promotional hats on the line, from any company we know, sent in.
God, no, these are all people just generously donating a hat, but it does come with the downside of the fact we might not like your hat. Bright orange for Generations in Jazz. Plain black, we see it a lot. Plain black with white embroidery for Rhino Solar.
That's the dunce for me this week.
Okay. And Ink Sports Nutrition. I think your brim's too complicated. Keep it simple for me, like Rhino Solar did, which is actually probably my favourite of the hats. But different hats for different chaps. All ladies. Robin, you are not a chap. Robin... Tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
Okay,
The man from Snowy River himself, Mr. Tom Berlinson.
Wow. Now, I can't say I've thought of Tom Berlinson. I didn't know he was the man from Snowy River. Haven't seen it. Here we go. Andy's got a vibe on.
Was he a judge on Dancing with the Stars?
Do you know, I can't say one way or the other on that one.
I usually know all the judges on Dancing
with the Stars. I saw an old clip of Dancing with the Stars.
And you think Tom Berlinson, I think from I saw Man Tom, from Snowy River, was on.
Yeah. Now, if it wasn't him, you've got it. But I think I remember seeing him and going.
Got it back at here, yes or no. Was it him? I mean, you might be wrong, but we can't.
This is a tough one, isn't it? Robin, you got yourself a hat.
The tension.
Oh, you get it.
Oh,
I'm going to get it.
Yes, gentlemen.
He swung around and Andy's
I just
now
think I couldn't with
Andy's
confidence.
Denying his memory.
I just couldn't with confidence.
Will you snatch the hat back if you're later proved right, Andy?
Yes. We won't send it out.
Okay. Robin, it is now.
You.
We are putting it in trust with our lawyers. And when you're when we've all cleared. Which one do you want, Robin? You want the Generations in Jazz orange plain black or complicated brim, red and black brim, black hat?
I think it has to be the red one. Ink Nutrition, please.
Oh, she's stepped it up and gone with the most complicated brim. It's Andy's favourite hat. Well done, Robin.
Nice, Robin. Amy.
Ahoy.
Ahoy, Amy.
Tell us something we haven't thought of for a while.
Okay, Fred and Big Tomo.
Fred and Big Tomo.
We have.
Very good. Great work, Amy.
Unfortunately,
now, no one's going to know who that is, but it is actually us. They were the two characters we played on Neighbours.
Characters we played on Neighbours. Margot Robbie was alongside her. She learned a lot from us, went on to be quite famous film acting.
She said, I can't do this. I'm too nervous. And we said, shut up.
You can do
Believe in yourself. We don't want to hear that kind of talk. You go and do Wolf of Wall Street. She did. Good on her. She's done well.
The reason why we have spoken about Fred and Big Tomo is Fifi Box is about to appear in Neighbours. We talked to Fife.
And we said, some tips.
Guess what, Fife?
Keep your scripts out of sight. Yeah. Don't let them see your scripts on scene, but certainly have them on set with you.
So you can read them.
Ross. Sorry, Amy. Ross, ahoy. How are you, sir?
Ahoy, boys.
Yeah. Ahoy. Ahoy, Ross. Have you got someone we haven't thought of for a while?
Sandy Tom.
Oh, bad luck, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Wish I was a punk rocker?
Yep.
Think about it all the time.
Yes.
Unfortunately, Ross, it is one of the classic I wonder what happened to her conversations we have in the studio. It's known as the Sandy Tom effect because, Ross, you're not to know this, and maybe we've mentioned it before on the show, but Ross, she comes up a lot because she actually was on our show.
Mm.
She came out. It was like
for that song.
March of that year, right? She came out, she was a guest, and she was promoting a concert in November.
Yeah.
And we went, oh, what are the chances? I mean, you've got one song.
Yes.
What are the chances that
some
the concert
people, and
goes
sometimes
ahead?
People can come out riding the wave of one.
And she was and popular.
Get a few other songs in the mix.
She was popular when she was here, but we gave it no chance of making it to the concert. And unfortunately, we were correct.
The concert
did not go ahead.
Justin, tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
That is the Sandy Tom effect.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Justin.
Jamie Lynn Spears.
Jamie Lynn Spears, Britney's mum.
Her little sister.
Sister. Yeah, sorry.
Britney's mum's other daughter.
Thought of her because just recently on clickbait.
Yep. You printed off a picture and put it above your bed?
No, it said it was. Here's what's happened to Britney's younger sister.
Jamie Lynn Spears.
And there was a picture of her now. And she just looked older.
And you looked at your watch and went, yep, I've only got 10 hours till the show's on. I think I've got time to have a read of this.
Unfortunately, Justin, it's a good one.
Sorry, mate, really good one.
But no, recently doing the rounds as an article, I would say 3.5 weeks ago.
Okay. And we've just heard, we've just been handed a slip of paper. Robin was given a win for Tom Berlinson, who was the man from Snowy River.
Mm.
Just said he was a judge in Australia's Got Talent in 2007 until he was replaced by Kyle Sandilands in season 4, who we have heard of, I don't know if Sandilands stuck around.
I can't say I was thinking that.
So she's got it.
I'm going to give it to her.
Of course.
Yes.
She's got it. Fantastic. Well done, Rob. Great to end on a good note. Oh, okay.
Ham, it's my turn to sing in the opener of this next game where we put out names of people we haven't thought of for a while. Feel like I'm going for a big scalp here. Feel like I'm probably biting off too much, and maybe I'll be laughed out of the studio.
No, there's never any laughing during this part. Even when I suggested Walt Disney the man, not Walt Disney the company, I remember there being a lot of solemn nods and a big round of applause, and the general vibe was, well done, Haim, you've done it.
Yep.
The game is, tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while. By that we mean this year. Got to be a household name. Mm. Can you get us? Have a go, Ando.
It's been a while since I've thought
about Demi Moore. Oh,
yeah. It's been a while since I've seen them.
I'm surprised you haven't thought of Demi Moore. I'd actually challenge it.
Well, I haven't thought of Demi Moore for ages.
We've mentioned the film Showgirls. Haven't we?
I'm sure we talked about that the other week.
Well, I definitely talked about the film with someone. Yeah. Maybe it was with Zoe. Yeah, well, I mean, I feel like you're thinking...
Jack, have you thought about Demi Moore recently?
I can't think of a time I would have thought of her this year, although she feels familiar.
That's my point. She feels familiar.
Like Walt Disney the Man.
No, Walt Disney,
you don't think of Walt Disney the Man.
All the time.
Yeah, but you don't think of the man. You think of the castle and the mouse. Doesn't matter.
I'll say it's better than Walt Disney.
Yeah. No one asked you, Jack. I turn that mic off and I'm going to cut the cord. My point is, Ando, I think of Kutcher quite a bit. You have mentioned Ashton Kutcher. You're telling me you never think of Demi Moore when you think of Ashton Kutcher.
It's all Kunis now.
That's 100% all roads lead to Kunis. There's not one thread that leads back to Moore. I've got you. 13-10-60. I would have been a fail.
Well, you can't tell me when you thought of Demi Moore.
I told you, I was talking about Showgirls the other week. I was positive we'd had the
conversation. Is she even in Showgirls? Isn't she in Striptease?
All those films. Oh. You think of more, you think of all of them. I can't help it that my mind works faster.
You can't help it trying poo-poo.
My mind works faster than most available computers on the market, and I was able to rapidly bring up an example. Here, do you want to hear the hats for this week?
She's not in Showgirls.
No, she's in Striptease. Who's the one that's in Showgirls? Elizabeth
Berkeley.
who would have been a good guess, because I didn't know her last name.
God, but you've been talking about Showgirls recently.
Yeah, but I wouldn't have known it was Elizabeth Berkeley.
Oh, jeez.
Here's the thing, Ando. No, you do take losing well.
Victory for me.
One of your key attributes is always happy to lose. Here's the hats for this week. 13-10-60, tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while. If you're successful, you have the shot at winning one of the three promotional hats I've selected from the bucket.
We need to prove it a lot better than Hamish did with his wishy-washy Showgirls references. But, Hame, what are the hats
still
today?
Still coping well with the loss. As always, you can send them in. Send in promotional hats. This is a very basic one. Safety Works Group.
Don't like it.
Yep, that's fair enough. It's very. It's better than we get sometimes, I would say.
Better than we get?
Yeah, well, I'd say...
Bottom 3% off for me. Basic black hat. Look, it's got a Velcro fastener and a pretty ordinary
logo. It's our second favourite fastener. But you know what? It's not attention-seeking. You can wear this, and if you've got a good enough face, you're not going to distract people
with
this
hat. If you're a roadie or if you're a stagehand,
big time.
You could wear that.
Big time.
Security.
Truck driver. Yep. You'd wear this, and someone would go, oh, well done. And it would look like you're being given it as a gift. Yes, it's not
all
gonna...
black hats today, are they?
They are all black hats.
Oh, there's a deep
this
blue.
This is a dark blue. Mm. Now, I see a lot to discuss for hat number two. It's navy blue. It's got brass ventilation holes. Yep. So some money has been spent on this hat. Yep. Got my least favourite fastener. Describe it, Ando.
Buckle
the
fastener.
The brass buckle. But again, I know it's expensive. It doesn't impress me.
Preferential for over 50s.
It's an over 50s hat. Yep. It comes from, obviously, a stables. You see there, it's got a horse sort of
but
logo.
There's too
on the
much. For the
so
over 50s,
much going
there's
on.
Too much embroidery.
This is a hat 100% built by a committee.
Yep.
Someone said, I want this on. Someone said, I want that on. You've got the website over the back of the hat. You've got some other logo on the side. Now, the front says, I love Dick Turpin, but Turpin is sort of hidden around the side of the hat.
Yeah.
I did a bit of research. Turns out this is from a stables. It's a horse.
Right.
They've got a stallion up there that I guess does a lot of work for them called Dick Turpin. That's him. That's the horse.
Right.
So you're sort of saying, I love that horse.
Okay.
Deliberately designed it to go, you know, you could.
I hated the first one and I disliked the second one more.
He's grumpy. I think it's because I got him with the Demi Moore stuff. This last one is a bit of it's a riddle. Because again, it's a black hat with a Velcro fastener.
It's better though. It's deeper peak. I mean, it feels a bit deeper as a...
All black,
a
fairly good quality, standard sort of run of the mill. I think this is just the first box you tick on the promotional hat box.
Yep.
And when you're ordering 100 or 1,000 by the group order. Mm. Just the embroidered logo, MGI. Who knows what the company is? Make it up. Mm. I've had a few goes here.
Okay.
The Marvin Gaye Institute. People that want to sing... does he sing Sexual Healing?
Yep.
Multiple great ideas.
Yep.
The company. Messy Grotty Industries.
which could be like a cleaning company, a museum of German initiatives. There's so many different things it could mean.
If you have any of those type of companies.
if you do run a museum of German initiatives.
This is the perfect hat for you.
You just got yourself a hat, you know, saves costs. And you'll need to save costs because I don't think that's a museum too many people want to go to.
Marcus joins us. Tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while. If we haven't thought of them this year, we will, of course, award you a hat.
Ahoy, boys.
Ahoy, Marcus. Who have you got on your mind?
Peter Everett from The Cooking Show.
Peter Everett. Are you talking about the...
Ready, Steady, Cook. He was the first host.
But is he the footballer?
As in Spider?
Peter Spider Everett? No, okay.
Just a different Peter Everett.
I don't think I've ever known who the other Peter Everett is.
Jack, can you shed more light on this guy?
He is just a similar namesake, but a different guy. I haven't thought about him, but he was the host of Ready, Steady, Cook.
I've never watched an episode. So, Marcus, we face a bit of an impasse here because, I mean, to us...
You'll recognise him.
And he's bringing him up now. And if you recognise him, Marcus has won a hat.
Nah. I recognise him, but I never know his name.
I don't know, though. If you recognise him...
Hey, look at this.
Sorry, if I recognise him...
He doesn't want a hat, mate.
I don't recognise that man. Sorry, Marcus. Really great try. It's as close as you can get to a goal without scoring. Yeah. Rachel, 13-10-60.
Ahoy.
Ahoy. Ahoy, Rach. Ahoy. We try our best. We've got to be fair here. But tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
Okay. Danny Bonaducci.
Danny Bonaducci. Okay.
Who's Danny Bonaducci?
Danny Bonaducci
Most famous redhead of all time.
Yeah, from back in...
I was in one of those...
Partridge Family.
It wasn't the... I was about to say Brady Bunch, but...
Close.
I will give this to you, Rachel, because I know the name more of as a punchline than knowing the guy.
I'm going to give it to you as well, Rachel. You got it, Rachel. You got a hat. I mean, you had to pick someone from 40 years ago, but that's okay.
That's all right. It hasn't come up.
Haim, go through the hats.
All right, Rachel, what do you want? Safety Works, MGO, I love Dick Turpin. Dick Turpin is a horse.
You guys really sold me the MGI hat.
Yeah, okay, good idea. We don't know that company, but you've got the hat. Well done, Rachel.
Yay!
Well done, Rachel. It's coming out to you.
Huge win.
Jennifer, the hat pool is lowered. Tell us something we haven't thought of for a while.
E.T.
No, sorry.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, I have thought of E.T. as well.
Yeah, we would...
All right, Jen, if you really want it... there's a show at the moment, a lot of people have seen it on Netflix called Stranger Things, and it is reminiscent of that era, like Stephen King and E.T. films, and a lot of people have discussed...
Yeah, but E.T.'s not in that.
But a lot of people have discussed E.T. in reference to the show Stranger Things.
You're not me, I'm not you, you're not Jack, Jack's not you, you're not Andy, Andy's not you.
Warnie's not Jack,
it
I'm not...
face, so how is it E.T.?
What's that?
It has no face. How is it E.T.?
Yes, I know they're not the same. But in the same way that I could discuss Mr. Sheffield and then think of Andy. they're not the same people, but they're very
white
similar.
Streak in my head.
We're just one white streak and a few hit Broadway productions away from them being the same person.
And me hiring Nanny.
Yep.
Thank you, Jennifer. Good attempt to argue the point, but the game is definitely where the web thought of them for a while. And
have you watched E.T. from front to back?
Did Jennifer ring up and say she hadn't thought of E.T. for a while?
But I think she had.
Even though she suggested him.
We said how.
Okay, Beck, wrap this up for us.
Beck, we've just come off a hotly contested no. Do you have someone we haven't thought of for a while?
Okay, well, I have tried before and failed, but today I think you haven't thought about Nora Jones.
It's pretty good.
Yeah,
She's definitely a household name, but maybe not your style.
Oh, my wife does play her, but it would be so rough of me to say, because Zoe's sort of in charge of all the music at home.
Yeah.
I feel like she's being played. Could I tell you the night? No. Did I watch E.T. that night? No, we've established that.
No.
I have to go, that's a green light from me, Ando.
It's a green light for me. You've got yourself a hat, Beck.
You've done it. Nora Jones is a cracker.
What hat would you like?
I did want the mystery hat, but I think it's gone. So I might go with, I think, the horsey one.
Do you want Dick Turpin?
Yeah.
Beck, you've got it, which means there's two new slots available. If you've got a company that has hats, send them in. We can't always promise a positive mention, but then again, it's a pretty cheap way to get on the radio.
It's been a while since I've thought
about Antonia Kidman.
Yeah, goodness. And it's been a while since I've seen them.
I was absolutely terrified for you for a moment because I thought you were going to do Antonio Banderas. Who I made several jokes about and had several jokes made of to me on the weekend. I thought, oh, no, Andy, so unlucky. I had a pretty heavy Antonio Banderas referencing weekend.
Yeah.
I've come on up an absolute Banderas bender. But you didn't. No. You played it smart.
Yeah.
You might have seen the fear in my eyes and diverted and gone to Antonio Kidman. The only thing, the only reason, I mean, sorry, if you've just tuned in, this is Tell Something We Haven't Thought Of for a while.
Yep.
A well-known person that we wouldn't have thought of all year. I've got to give it to you because I can't come up with enough evidence to disprove it, but I feel
you'd love
like,
to, though.
Well, I feel like the first thing that popped into my head is, does she do those, like, brand power type ads?
No.
Like, things where she goes, hi, you know, I'm a mum and I do this at home. I feel like I've seen...
She used to a long time ago.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, that's... I mean, I'm not taking it away from you. Have a hat. That's how the game works.
If the reason why this came up for me as a good one was a friend of mine said, hey, what's Nicole Kidman's sister's name again?
Bingo.
And none of us could get it.
And we had Antonio Kidman.
We all had to Google it, and then that's when I thought, oh, well, that will be a good one.
This is good.
Right, hats are plenty.
Here's how it works. 131060, obviously people are calling in. Don't let that deter you. We will take random callers, even though things do seem to be chockers there. Still have a go, because people take this game very seriously, Ando. It's the number one thing. We have people approach us in the street and whisper to us, and sometimes you go, oh, why did that person just whisper Dennis Rodman to me? And then you figure it out.
Well, that's a goodie.
Here are the hats. You've seen... Let's start with the elephant in the room.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen...
Mammoth in the room, it seems.
This
what's a yak?
Is what you covet. This is the best hat we've ever been sent.
Yes.
And I say that unashamedly.
Yeah, it is.
Jack, would you agree?
Yeah. I wouldn't wear it.
It is from Yak Ales, as in fat yak ales and beers. It's a trucker hat, but the front panel... It's brown. Front panel... And brim of the hat
is a strong yak fur.
It's like what you imagine the Cookie Monster would feel like if you patted him, but brown with the yak logo in there. Jackie, are you telling me that's not the best hat we've ever had?
I'll wear it to a fancy dress party.
Oh,
what's the theme?
Yeah.
Come with a dog-like hat. No, it's like a dog. It's like wearing a dog on
your
head.
It's great.
And you're certainly going to gain friends. There's no way you're losing friends, though.
Well done,
if you wear
yak.
That. We now move on to your more, and sorry, we should point out too, these are hats sent in by companies, you know, providing us with
sponsored.
Them. Well, I suppose it is sponsored, but it's just, we just ask people for hats and we do get a good selection of promotional hats. Ooh. Next hat off the rank, we're looking at a feel, we've seen this before, the old stripe on the peak.
Describe my face.
It looked like a man that's seen this all before and is getting too old for this crap.
Yep.
And that's how I feel too. We've got a plain black hat from a company called Swivel Pole. I assume they make poles, and I assume they're bloody good at them.
And the ones that swivel. The problem with their
they
hat...
They probably make static
it's
poles
got
too.
Velcro fastener. It's black.
That's our
But
least
they've
favorite.
Tried to get wiki. They've spent their money on the peak, which is what we recommend don't. We recommend keep your peak simple.
I don't know why it seems to be a thing in promotional hats to add a colour of piping to the peak and then have half the peak filled in, half not... Oh, you know what I reckon? I reckon it on the form where you buy the promotional hats, do you want a jazzy peak is the last box? And everyone's ticked no to all the options and they went,
something.
Oh, we can't get the cheapest hat.
Yep.
Let's jazz up the peak. You shouldn't have swivel pole,
yep.
But if I need a pole, I know who to talk to.
Mm.
King Chrome.
It's good.
Not a bad hat. Nice, bold, red hat.
Buckle fastener, your least favourite.
I don't like a buckle fastener. It makes me feel like an old man who got a free hat with a sports car. But I don't...
King Chrome, I think
a raised embroidery on the...
I think they're a spanner. I think they're like tools.
I hope I'm not mentioning a competitor here, but they've got to be a cousin of Sid Chrome. Jack's pointing to his wrist. That's not where you'd wear the hat, Jack. You'd wear the hat on your head.
He might be telling us to get to the song so we can take some calls. Anyway, your chance to win one of those three hats. I'd recommend the fat yak.
You know the hat you
the
want,
King
though.
Chrome. Stay away from Swivel Pole.
Well, Swivel Pole, look, you know, it'll get the job done, but it's probably going to go third.
Tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while. Simply ring up. For your chance to win a hat sent in.
If we have thought of that person this year, you sadly cannot win a hat that's been sent in by various companies. Running through the hats very quickly, a bright red one from King Chrome. I think they make tools. Plain black, a disappointing peak, an orange swipe on the peak from a company called Swivel Pole.
Mm.
I believe they make poles. Then,
what has been termed the best hat we've ever been sent.
Yep.
Brown trucker hat. The peak and front panel of the hat are covered in fur from Yak Ales, from the beer company. Can I throw something out here, guys? Yeah. And we've been doing this segment almost all year.
Yep.
This hat is so good.
Mm.
The furry hat, this kind of dog yak hat.
Yep.
People have to get two in a row.
No.
Yeah, they do. We can't just give it away to someone that gets one.
No, someone can get it, but...
No, they can't.
I'll say that. How about this then? If no one wins today, you can keep it.
No, I don't want to keep it. I just want someone to really earn it.
Jason joins us.
Jace, how are you, mate?
Not too bad. How are you guys?
Very good, sir. Sorry to introduce a brand new rule, but, I mean, the hat's so good.
Yeah. No, it's up for grabs, mate. It's up for grabs. Jason, tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
Uncle Cracker, the singer who sung Follow Me.
Oh, I have no idea who you're talking about.
Mate, that's a huge out of bounds on the full for me. Still not familiar with this song. I mean, it obviously exists because Jack found it in the computer.
You don't know how
Hey, Jace, it's a no for me because I never knew who
sorry,
was
Jack,
on that
song. Jace, we do have to have had them in our head before.
What was his name? Uncle Cracker?
Uncle Cracker?
Uncle Cracker.
Cracker. Okay. Much better.
It was a number one song. On what chart, Jace?
Much better than Uncle Clacker.
Got it right in the Uncle Clacker.
Sorry, Jace. Close to a hat. Edwina.
Ahoy.
Ahoy. Ahoy, Edwina. 131060. Tell us someone we haven't thought of for a while.
I think you haven't thought of David Hofflin from Neighbours.
You are unlucky.
Because I thought you'd mispronounced David Hasselhoff for a sec before I remembered there is a guy called David. We had him on the show.
Yes.
But it's spelt David, isn't it?
Yes, it's spelt David.
I remember about 95% of the interview was us clarifying.
Yeah, we pranked him.
Yeah.
No, we didn't have him on the show.
Yeah, I wonder why we would have him on.
We pranked him on and we just kept
calling him David.
And he kept having to correct us. So, David, the unfortunate thing for you, Edwina, is I talked about that exact prank with Robert Millsy Mills just recently, about 6 weeks ago.
God, what a poker game that would have been. What I would have given for a seat at the table. Andy Lee, Robert Mills,
yes.
Guy Sebastian,
$35
number one
buy
topic, $35 buy in. Bring your best David anecdote.
David. Grant. Grant, tell us something we haven't thought of for a while. This is the last one because we're running behind. You have a chance at the best hat we've ever been sent. Yep. Otherwise, that will be jackpotted.
Jeannie Little.
Jeannie Little. Ah, no.
It's good for me.
Was she on Beauty and the Beast?
She was on lots of different things. Not Beauty and Beast, no. She was on TV. Are you talking about the...
She was sort of a commentator, though, wasn't she? Sort of like a, you know, talking about current events, that
she
sort of thing.
She had a really horrible voice.
Okay.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
I mean, she's still with us.
So, Haim, I mean, it's good for me.
We were talking about the show Beauty and the Beast. Remember that panel show?
Yes.
I mean...
Was she on Beauty and the Beast is the question. And, I mean, are you...
Is it a no? She wasn't.
She was.
She was on it.
Yes.
Sorry. Because, I mean, does that count as we were talking about that on the weekend?
Well, did you think of her specifically?
Yeah, I mean, I saw the panel. I don't know everyone's names.
Okay. No hat for you, Grant.
Sorry, Grant. I mean,
it's tough. Yes. She was one of the beauties alongside the beast.
You be the judge here, Andy.
Stan Zemanek.
I saw Zemanek, and I saw an array of beauties beside him. Yes, I didn't know specifically who everyone was, but her face popped into my head. Blonde hair, tight back in a pony often.
And a lot of eye makeup.
Yep. I mean, I've got it, haven't I?
Sorry, Grant.
Your chance again next week. You will need two in a row correct to win the best hat ever. Is a new rule, Ando.
It's not.
It's been a while since I've thought
about Gail Garcia Bernal.
Yeah. And it's been a while since I've seen him.
Whenever you're not confident, you always follow it up with, that's pretty good.
Come on,
guys.
You know Gail Garcia Bernal? Incredibly famous Spanish actor. Or possibly, where's he from? Maybe Mexican? Yeah, he's Mexican.
What?
You know Gail Garcia Bernal? He won an Oscar.
What did he win for? Most unknown person.
They won a Golden Globe. Got a Golden Globe last year.
That's pretty good.
Jack, you tell me you don't know Gail Garcia Bernal.
No, name one film he's been in.
The one about going on the road trip when he was Che Guevara. Gail Garcia Bernal. He's the go-to for any Mexican. But Sam, you know Gail Garcia Bernal.
This is the.
He looks familiar. That's all I can
say. Are you joking? He's probably one of the top 10 most famous actors in the world.
You can't even name a film. You can't.
Well, I know that he's in a film called Watua Mama Tambien, but no one will know that film. But he's in.
Like no one knows.
What's he been in? Mozart in the Jungle.
Oh, yeah. No one knows that.
Motorcycle Diaries, 2004. Yeah. No, he's in some good stuff. People, all right.
Yeah.
Please flood our social media
with
praise for Gail Garcia Bernal to show Andy at Hamish Andy on Twitter. Please flood it.
Boy, will his management be going, wow.
No, flood it. Doesn't it? I mean, or just acknowledge he's a well-known person.
He certainly is not.
That's crazy you don't know Gail Garcia. But
it's certainly not crazy.
He really is. He really would be probably one of the top three most famous Mexican actors of all time, if not the most.
No.
Name a better one.
Well, I think, I mean, Benicio del Toro is Spanish, I think, but yeah, not Mexican, he plays a lot of Mexican.
Not authentically enough. He's basically a young Benicio.
Okay. Anyway.
Huge.
Go to the hats.
Sorry. Okay. Well, so the game is tell us something we haven't thought of in a while. And as you can see, sometimes when you really think a person's well known, you can find out that they're not as well known as you think.
See, the hard thing is in this game, we have to know of them to be able to haven't heard of them for a while.
Mm.
We just never heard of Gail Banjo, whatever he's
that at. Is so crazy. You know Gail Garcia, but
I'll get Gail Garcia a minute there.
Okay. But if you can name someone successfully that we both know and acknowledge we haven't thought of this year.
While,
then you could win one of these outstanding hats.
Mm-hmm.
Or are they outstanding? All sent in by companies, generously donated.
Send your hats in.
Send your hats in, promotional hats.
Like the top one there, Ham.
You like this one?
Yeah.
I don't really get it.
What is it?
I thought they were dogs. I've just realised. I think it's a sheep and a cow outline.
Yeah.
Basic black and white trucker, white front panel, maybe a little small for my liking. One to pick if you're a pinhead or a peahead.
Okay.
Theherdonline.com. Not sure what they do. Possibly farm supplies, could be a butcher.
Yep.
But a nice, simple logo there. If you're into livestock or you like eating meat,
and a nice you don't hat, want to show black, off, white, not showing off.
Just really.
This next one's disgusting.
Well, I mean, it's a cheese company, but they've got an inbuilt bottle opener on the peak of the hat.
Which I don't think would
work. Said it before, I'll say it again. I know what you're doing. You're trying to create some sort of Swiss Army hat.
Yep.
But we know the pressure needed to open a bottle. You've got a fabric hat.
Yes.
With a metal bottle opener built into the brim.
You'd have to take the hat off.
It obviously comes at huge expense. If you think anyone's opening this with their hat still on their head, the hat's flying off, your beer's not getting open, it's a classic lose-lose, and it doesn't do Hunter Bell cheese any favours. But anyway, that'll be available for you if you want it. Next, we've got a classic white tennis visor.
The visor.
Velcro at the back.
Yep.
I accept Velcro as a visor fastener.
Yes.
I don't like it as a cap fastener.
Yeah, I agree.
But I'll take a Velcro back on a white visor.
What company?
It is simply to promote mangoes, Australian mangoes. I assume they've got an event coming up called the Mestival, which probably is just where you messily eat mangoes.
Yep.
I don't think it would be where you throw them at each other because that would be a waste of delicious mangoes.
Why do you assume that?
Well, you just eat them Mestival. And create a mess because it's called Mestival.
Okay, cool.
It's
okay.
Got written
it's,
on
it's written on
but
it.
But I mean, right. I assume it's where you just eat mangoes and it's messy.
Yep.
Not like the tomato festival where you waste all those tomatoes.
Great. I didn't realize it was written on it. That's why when you went with that assumption, I was like,
yep. I'm just using the standard rule of read something in English, think about it, say the thing it made you think of.
Yeah.
It is an iron-on transfer. That's cheap.
Hmm.
But on the other hand, maybe they're putting more money into their mangoes. So that's the one thing we can take out of the fact that it's a cheaply made visor.
There are your three hats up for grabs. Try and tell us something we haven't heard of for a while or thought about for a while.
I was thinking of Olympians to get you with before, but always tough in an Olympic year.
Yes.
Because you do think of a lot of Olympians.
Yeah.
Now, I don't want to just keep banging on about the one I nominated one song ago, Gail Garcia Bernal.
Sounds like you do want to keep banging on about it.
Now, you say he's a nobody.
Yep.
How many Twitter followers do you reckon this nobody has?
I don't care.
2.2 million.
Yeah, but that's Mexican stars. I could name...
I mean, yeah, a lot of his tweets are in Spanish.
Yeah. I mean, I could name a few Chinese stars.
Yeah, would give never me heard. Five.
After a bit of research. that probably have 15 million.
Yeah, just saying, interesting. He's got 2 million.
No.
I'm going to follow him.
No.
I'm interested in what he's up to.
He has time on his hands, I think.
Here's the thing. Okay, so that was a fail from me, bizarrely.
Amanda on 131060, tell us something we haven't thought about for a while.
Bo Brady.
Bo Brady.
Who's Bo Brady?
Noah from Home and Away.
You've unfortunately stumbled into a show that hasn't really watched Home and Away since the flat top days.
Yeah, or
Flathead?
I actually said this
Flathead.
Last night I flicked on Channel 7 Home and Away. I've realised I never, ever watched an episode of Home and Away.
I mean, I was religious with it until I was about 16.
Yep.
But, I mean, that's going back three or four years now.
That's sorry, Amanda.
And that is how it
happens.
There's
probably people in cars going, yeah, Bo Brady, what a ripper.
I've got his TV hits poster on my wall.
Yeah, but not us. Reese, 131060.
Ahoy,
Reese.
Darkwing Duck.
Who?
Darkwing Duck.
Darkwing Duck. Yeah, cartoon back in the day.
What was his
character? I know it and haven't thought of it.
It's yours then, Ham, because
Is Jason Alexander, Reese?
I think his real name was like Drake Mallard or something. He was a spin-off from DuckTales.
Hang on, I'm thinking of the one that George from Seinfeld voiced.
Jason Alexander.
I think that was Darkwing Duck? I mean, if that's it, I think
it's Jim Cummings, maybe?
Oh, right.
And we thought Gail Garcia, but now it was odd.
I don't know Darkwing Duck, Ham. I don't know if it was across.
But hang on a sec. If I put this in, if it is voiced by Jason Alexander, I'm going to give you the win.
Mm-hmm.
And you chat for a sec, because I've got a few issues here with the computer.
Jim Cummings, Christine Kavanagh, and
Don't know it. Don't know it.
Don't know it?
Sorry, Reese.
Sorry, bud.
Sorry, man.
He was right. I mean,
but Reese sounded American, and you sensed that maybe it was bigger in America than it was here.
And Reese did tell us Jim Cummings, and we both decided not to listen to him.
Who's the executive producer here of Darkwing Duck? Reese.
Jessica. Jessica,
hi.
Tell us something we haven't thought of for a while.
John Cedar.
Pretty good.
Isn't he in Trainwrecked?
You mean the wrestler?
No, Cedar, S-E-D-A. So he was in
Not Cena.
Oh.
No, Cedar. But he was in a movie with Jennifer Lopez called Selena.
Oh, sorry. I mean,
Gail Garcia-Bernal's the most famous person that's been mentioned. So
I haven't known a single person so far.
Having some huge swings and misses here.
Sorry, Jessica. Jace.
Yeah, Jace.
Do you want to give someone else that... You know,
we did say it was going to be a tough week because, I mean, it's the end of the year and we have thought a lot of people. Jace, ahoy.
Ahoy, boys.
What are you thinking, Jace?
Good luck. Who are you
birthday,
got?
Andy?
Oh, happy birthday, mate. I don't do birthdays, buddy.
Yeah, he does, Jace. He forces it down our throat.
Wilson.
Who the hell is
that the next door neighbour on Home Improvement?
Oh, you got me, mate.
I mean, I got you as in I've stumped you or I'm correct?
You are correct.
Okay. Is his name Wilson?
That's the character name. His real name's Earl Hinman. Oh,
this is unbelievable.
I don't think I've thought of Wilson for a while, but...
I don't think I have either. I mean, we do talk about him a lot on the Tim Allen... I'm going to give it to you, Jace.
Okay, well done, Jace. You got yourself a hat.
We're really well done, mate. Probably haven't thought of Wilson, the neighbour from Home Improvement, for a while. What do you want, mate? Do you want the chicken and cow, the herd... One, the hat with the bottle opener in the rim.
Wouldn't recommend it.
Or the white
visor
with the iron-on mango transfer.
I think I'll go with the bottle opener. So when I win a beer this Friday,
yep.
He's going back to play Layla.
Well done, Jace. Okay, you've got what I thought was the worst hat of the bunch. Kerry, wrap this up for us. Tell us something we haven't thought of for a while.
The great Aussie legend, Peter Russell Clark.
Yeah, sorry, mate. We get him a bit. We think of him often.
sorry. We were actually, and this is just a tip for all other players.
Yeah.
We were going through the other day who was the original chef. Like, we're talking about Jamie Oliver, Curtis Stone.
Yeah.
And we thought, we went Peter Russell Clark.
And then Huey.
Huey Hewitson.
Healthy, wealthy and wise.
Gabriel Gatte was in there at some point.
Yep.
But yeah, we went through the whole list of them.
So yeah, Kerry, apologies, mate, but he's right up there with, you know, Peter Russell Clark, your Nicky Webster's, your Steve Urkel's.
Was there another French chef in...
Jeff Jantz?
That's the one. That's the one. That he's also...
Finally, I've redeemed myself for Gail Garcia-Bernal.